got another backer on that. Here he is again. All right, hold on. Hey, Donnie Cates.
Ethan, how you doing, pal?
Good, I'm live right now. Like, people can hear you, so I'm warning you of that right now. Like, I'm actually doing a live stream right now. You want to say hi to Comicsgate?
Every time I look at you, I don't understand why you let the things you did get so out of hand. You'd have managed better if you'd had it planned. Now why'd you choose such a backward time in such a strange land? If you'd come today, you could have reached the whole nation. Israel in 4BC had no mass communication.
Don't you get me wrong.
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 I want you to imagine that the industry that you gave 25 years of your life to simultaneously worked together to convince the general public that you were a Nazi. And I want you to wonder to yourself if you would ever forget that or ever forgive that. Would you do that? I want you to think about what it would be like if leftist media publications on the internet all converged with the help and support of people who you consider to be your peers to convince the general public that you were a bigot, a homophobe, a racist, and a Nazi. Is there any way that you would ever forgive those circumstances?
Tell me what you think about your friends at the top. Now who'd you think besides yourself was the pick of the crop? Buddha, was he where it's at? Is he where you are? Could Mohammed move a mountain or was that just PR? Did you mean to die like that? Was that a mistake? Or did you know your message was fear?
Don't make peace with me. Make peace with them, Donnie, because I'm not going to betray my fans by publicly endorsing your behavior. All of this positivity shit is bullshit. Apologize to the fans who supported you, and you demonize them all when you demonize Comicsgate. Oh, for God's sake. What is that? Is a rap group. Here we go.
This is going to be a tough one. My name is Anus, Anus Silly Man. This town needs someone like me, someone that can make a difference. I've trained my body to do things that people just don't understand. People say that I'm insane and that I don't have powers. I do have powers. I can run really fast. And when I smoke crack, I can fly, just like a beautiful angel.
And that's why here at Pro Penis, we develop the biggest dicks a human can get. But I tell you, god damn, it's a hard little project. So will you please enjoy this wiper from our team? Giant John Wodick.
Clap. All the time.
Ice cream! Ice cream! Ice
chocolate
cream.
Cones! Get 4 or 5. Go!
I gotta take a piss to my sister!
By adding length and girth, 5 ways your penis can be extended.
Small homeless girl laying down. Hold on!
Fat boys. Just walk around.
I can jump and shit. I think I've pissed in my diaper.
Mm-hmm. ending? I can.
I'm gonna take this city bitty world by storm, and I'm just getting warm.
You see, what it is what it is. It don't matter about what it was, since what it was is what it was. That is to say, it isn't what it was nor what it were. What it were is nothing like what it will be, nor will it be that which it were. You see what I'm saying here? What it was isn't what it were, nor was it what it is. But what it is will be what it is, since what it is what it be. You following?
What the hell, Anna?
I think that we should assume that he is happy.
Okay.
He seems to be repeating the same crap over and over again.
I can slow it down if you're not following. I mean, I just don't know how else to explain it to you. It is what it be. Don't ask me how it is, because how it is how it is, which, again, is completely different to what it is.
I can't understand. I got one, Ethan. This Rippa hurts. God damn it, John. Not now.
Does that answer your question? I can slow it down if you're not following. I mean,
he's starting to make my head spin.
Don't ask me how it is, because how it is how it is.
Mr. Keon, where are they transporting him? God damn it.
It beats me.
They appear to have transported the captain down to the planet's surface. I'm unable to lock onto them due to a constant stream of bullshit coming from the other ship.
Hello, everybody. Hi. How are you guys doing? It's me, Ethan Van Sciver. This is Comic Artist Pro Secrets. It's like a Saturday morning trash cast. Hi. Sorry, I had to clear my throat there. I thought I would do it as loudly and eccentrically as possible. Good to be with you guys. Pleasure. We're going to do a show today. I think we're going to do one tonight, too. We'll do our regularly scheduled trash cast. I know, you're all worried about that. Don't worry. We'll be here. We're going to do our trash cast. We didn't do it last night because I was at the Phillies game. It's the Phillies game with my father, watching the season opener, watching the Phillies utterly humiliate themselves. But I loved it. I had the best time. I was in my Phillies overalls. You know, I looked like a clown show. It was really cool. Had a good time. Watched, got there early so I could see the opening festivities and ceremonies and things like that. It's opening day, you know, it's a big deal. I watched, man, I saw this kid and his mom come down. You know, there was the Phillies manager was standing down by the front. He's going, come on down. And I watched this kid come down with his mom, and all the Phillies came out. They were signing stuff for this kid, man, giving him balls and bats and everything, autographed. Taking pictures with him and everything. I was like, damn, that kid's lucky. I wish I were him. You know, why can't I get stuff like that? That kid is really lucky. Well, he was a make-a-wish kid. He was dying of cancer. So, I told his mom. I said, let me know when you want to sell those. Ethan was in the Philly Fanatic costume. I would fit, too. I love the Philly Fanatic. Dude, I am so excited. We're going back again today. That kid was a young Ed Piskor. Ed Piskor, I bet he wishes he was that kid right now. Ed Piskor going through utter hell. His friend Jim Rugg denounced him yesterday. my attitude about this is, and you know, there's no need. Like, everybody's going, Jim Rugg, what is your... Jim Rugg, why won't you release a statement about your friend? How come you won't do that? And a lot of pressure. Like, we want to hear from Jim Rugg. Well, I mean, yeah, because people want to be entertained by this further. You know, I'm stringently anti-cancel culture, right, guys? I mean, it's interesting. I like to watch it now. I like to watch it happen because, you know, it happened to me. So it's interesting to see it happen to other people. But people just wanted Jim to just kind of come forward and, like, say something just because they wanted him to add to the story, add to their own entertainment. And when he finally did, I mean, it was just disgraceful. Jim Ruggart. In light of this past week's shocking revelations, dude, there is no possible way that you didn't know that your Ed Piskor friend there, your pal, your Piskor pal, wasn't macking on girls. You knew that. You know, and you might have even understood or known that a few of them were very young. You might have known that. So there's no way that this was a shocking revelation to you. You spent all this time with him, you work with him. You had to have suspected something. But even still, he goes, I find it necessary to reevaluate my professional associations to ensure they align with my values of respect and I'm so sure that you're full of respect and integrity. Therefore, I have ended my working relationship with Ed Piskor. You know, Jim, you know, you don't really have to do this. You don't really have to kneel to the mob. I know it seems like you do, that, like, you know, you're under all this pressure to come out and say something. But you see, either way, you're taking an L here. Your career is over. Jim, you're not coming back from this. You know, you are tied to Ed Piskor. So, you know, there are two L's. Two L's. I can't get it to work. Two choices. One of the choices is that you distance yourself like a coward and basically try to save yourself and pretend that you didn't know what was going on. And I'm full of respect and integrity. Those are my professional values. Or you could stand by your friend. And the thing about the comic book industry is it's full of cowards. It's full of people who just will not stand by their friends. They love being terrified of each other more than they love each other. I will tell you that. This is just fear. It has nothing to do with anything. This is just somebody who's terrified of it happening to him too. It would have been great for Jim to say something along the lines of, yeah, although I didn't know about this, and I find this to be, you know, this one thing to be a big mistake of his, and probably a weakness of his character, he's still my friend, okay? So go fuck yourselves. That would have been cool. I would have been like, wow, dude, so there are some SJWs out there that actually have a pair on them. That would have been great. But no, instead you get this, which is expected, and it's entirely expected, the way this stuff goes down. Many of you know that let me just go back from the beginning. I'm a storyteller, so I want to tell you guys another story here. You might not know about this. So I got to tell you from the start. John Mayall and Shane Davis decided that they wanted to open up a booth at a big convention at C2E2. They planned it and everything. Shane Davis was going to open it up under 9 Lives, three 20-foot tables. And they approached me about it too. They wanted me to be involved in it. And I said, okay, guys. I said, are you sure? Like, did you... I said, did you get this? They said, yes. Yeah, it's all settled. We got the tables. I was like, this is weird. Like, there's no, like, in my heart, I knew there's no way this is real. There's no possible way that, like, this is a legit thing because I know this industry and I know these cowards and I understand who they are. And I really don't think that anything has changed. I think everything is just the same as it ever was. So if I'm wrong about that, I'll be amazed. But these guys, you know, they wanted to do these triptych comic books that they would fund. They would have these great convention variants of our books that they would be they would offer to people to help fund the booth. And then also we would sell the books there at the convention. We'd have these exclusive. They were excited about this idea that they'd come up with. And I was added to it. This was a new thing for me. I wasn't aware that this was something we're going to do. C2E2 is... the heart of the comic book industry. I want you to understand, like, it's not like MegaCon. It's not like, you know, one of these other shows like Dallas, you know, in Dallas or one of these things. It's not like one of these shows. It's not a Wizard World show. It's like the heart of the beating heart of the comic book industry. They co-own Emerald City Comic Con, which is 100% woke. Like, think about going to Seattle. You know what I mean? You think it's bad, like, you think it's bad in Chicago, Seattle, you know, these places, some of these California cons. I was amazed. I couldn't believe it. But we did it. We planned on going. We got everything together. We got the hotel rooms and everything. We were going to, like, hang out with you guys. We were going to have a good time. And then, lo and behold, suddenly, out of the blue, Shane Davis receives a message from them, like, panicky message, just like, we're not letting you, like, you, no, like, there's a harassment clause, and we're not going to allow you to be, how you tricked us, and all this stuff, and they sent Shane a letter about it and everything. They were complaining about the fact that, like, you know, we have gender, like, we kind of are going to make people who have gender dysphoria feel unsafe. This is craziness. We're the ones that are unsafe. Manifestly, like, we're not there to cause any trouble at all. We wouldn't be there to cause any harm. We would be there to sell our books and hang out and meet with fans and stuff like that. The normal things that you do at conventions. We would be the ones that would be putting ourselves at risk by going out in public at one of these conventions with crazy lunatic SJWs, all of whom have fantasies, have these superhero fantasies about punching us and attacking us and all of these things because they think that we're Nazis, we would be the ones in harm's way. So they canceled on us and told us it was because of, we would be making people feel unsafe there, which was infuriating. Shane has the message. Shane's like, should I release it? And I said, I'm not sure yet. And if you do release it, like, I'm not sure, like, where you should release it to first, like the media or what. I have contacted the Comic Book Legal Defense Fund about this. It's not that I want to go. It's that this is just bullshit. At some point, I was sitting upstairs and having breakfast with Andrew and my dad. My dad's furious about this, too. And I was like, the thing about it is that Comicsgate has made me very happy. Like, I am comfy right now. You know, I'm okay. I'm drawing the comics that I want to draw. Nobody has stopped me from drawing my comics. I have everything that I want in life. You know, I'm fairly comfortable and content. I'm getting fat. I'm enjoying my life. But this isn't over yet. You know what I mean? Like, I'm something like this happens, and you realize that, like, Comicsgate is not done. It's still a thing. It's still something that needs to be fought. And we need to fight it. It's us. We need to actually fight this. We need to get up off our fat and lazy asses and do something about this and push back, because otherwise they've completely won. Now, does this mean that, like, you know, we're going to push real hard and get to be at C2E2? Manifestly, I don't like to go where I'm not wanted. I don't want to go to C2E2 if they're, like, determined to not have me there. If they're determined, if they insist on forcing me to not be there, you know, that's fine. I don't want to go where I'm not wanted, obviously. But we still need to fight and push back. And obviously, you know, the idea of doing appearances and conventions of our own and building our own thing is important. And it's something that I let drop because, frankly, I'm busy. I've got all these other comics to do that are late. You know, I've got other obligations. But For the Fans Fest has to happen. I mean, we do have to actually do this. We do have to continue to push to make a difference, to create something of our own. And I don't know if you call it a parallel economy. I don't like that phrase. I think it's fucking gay. But we do have to make something of our own rather than trying to leech onto something that's been corrupted, you know, something that's politically discriminatory, something that's flawed, something that's full of incredibly weak people who will turn on their best friends on a dime just because of accusations from a couple of girls. They'll turn on their life. Bros before hoes, dude. These guys will turn on each other. They're friends. Turn on them. They won't just say, you know, hey, listen, he did something wrong, but he's my friend. That's what normal people do. These SJWs utterly, utterly spit on each other, throw each other under the buses at the slightest of infractions and inconveniences. Being a friend, being somebody's friend. Hey, Jim Rugg, being somebody's friend means standing by them in good times and bad. I understand when things are great, and you've got a big hit YouTube channel, and you know Todd McFarlane might come on there and be interviewed by you, and everything's sunshine and lollipops, it's easy to be someone's friend then. But when SJWs, people just like you, actually turn on your friend and bring down hard times, intend to destroy his life. And by the way, I'm here to kind of sit back and chuckle. I'm eating popcorn. I hate cancel culture, but I hate Ed Piskor too. So this is a wash for me. But you know what? Jim Rugg, it shouldn't be a wash for you. This guy's your friend. Why are you such a fucking pussy? Why won't you stand by him? You're going down anyway. You're going down with the ship. You might as well go down with the friendship. Just seems like a better thing to do. And every single day these people disgust me. Getting kicked out of C2E2 because some people who don't understand what's in their pants means that's what their set of pronouns is. People who are struggling with a very basic idea of their gender identity, they are going to feel unsafe by my being there. These people are in showers. These people are in little girls, men in little girls' restrooms, and I'm the one that makes them feel unsafe? You got to be fucking kidding me. These people are crazy. I don't want to be around them. I really don't. I don't want to be around these people. I have been like pretty happy about the idea that, you know, I don't need any of this. I'm going to do my own thing. I'm building my own thing here. And I have. I've built my own thing. It's wonderful. CyberFrog is excellent. Everybody loves CyberFrog, except for the haters. The fucking haters. They love CyberFrog. It's all good. But the temptation to go somewhere where you guys might be so I can give you guys pats on the back, not handshakes, you know better than to shake my hand, but maybe even huggies, you know, sign your comic books for you, talk to you. That temptation was too great for me, and I forgot myself. I forgot about the reality of all of this because I wanted to meet you guys so badly and hang out with Shane and John. But the reality has not changed. This is still a thing, and therefore, we must create something new. We must do something of our own. And I feel, you know, like getting up out of my big comfy chair. Big comfy fat chair, sitting here like this, watching the Phillies and doing something about it. I don't know about you guys, but let's do something about it. Let's make a difference and let's actually make a con. Talking to my wife about it and just being like, can you imagine? Florida is a place that we mentioned. Can you imagine having a convention right near Graceland? So we could go to Elvis's house. I want to be where Elvis was, you know, having a nice convention there, you know, next to Graceland would be awesome too. I want to go to conservative places. I want to go to states and cities and towns where there are normal, hardworking people who still value escapism. Don't need their views about gender perversion and all these other things reflected back at them. I don't want to be around those people. I don't want to be around the left. The radical left. I want to be around thinking normal people who just want to have fun with comics, and that's most of you. Kentucky, let's go. Alabama, let's go. Memphis, Tennessee, Texas, great idea here. Space Monkey says, Ethan, did you know Cody might be an illegitimate grandson of Elvis? Is that true? Got that Elvis DNA? Southern Virginia and the Carolinas, all these places are great, guys. You know, we need to do this. All right, we do. We need to do it. So, I'm going to, I am recommitting myself here and now. Recommitting myself. to make a difference and to make it so that comic book creators who do not align with radical left-wing, intersectional feminist, gender-perverted values, anti-values, can still enjoy comics, sell their comic books, make their comic books, meet up with each other, have some drinks, have a good time, party. I'm doing it, guys. What are they saying about Cody's grandma, says Leo Schlitz? They're saying she a hoe. They're saying that, well, I don't, honestly, you know, if any of those women had an opportunity to sleep with Elvis Presley and did not do so, they're stupid. I told Anna, that Star Wars girl, this. She did have an opportunity to have sexual intercourse with Sean Lennon. How about Utah? You think Utah sounds great. I'd love to go back there. And she did not do it. Anna did not have sexual intercourse with Sean Lennon. She could have had John Lennon's grandbaby inside of her, but she didn't. So that's on Anna. For the Fans Fest in 5 years, 2029, says Turner Watt Studios. We could do it next year. We really could. I just have to devote myself to it. And then Schneely gifted 5 memberships. Turner Watt Studios says morning show. San Antonio the link. Don't you miss the morning show with me and Antonio? We would start out every morning, with the... Where's our music? Do we have it? Yeah, I think this was it. We would start out every, It's the morning show, Comics Gay Live. Fundraiser's still live. Anything helps keep my cars as I draw local moms. John Cipolla. I hate the criticism now. You and earlier Doomcock has gotten. You guys are my first and foremost creators. The rest are shadows. Joe Frago says, whoa, good morning, Comicsgate, for $5 from Joe. Base Bunny Love. Animated Cyberfrog looks fire. You think so? You like that? Yeah, these guys are doing this kind of test animated thing. You want to see it again? Looks good. Looks really good, guys. Hey, what's up? Says Lord Tatman's Comics. Unlimited Power says gonna watch Godzilla versus Kong today with the family. Sean Cullen, tell me how it is. Happy Trashter Caster. Hail Comicsgate. Wilberforce Wooster. You can fool me. You were gonna steal Mark Brooks' chair. I would, yeah. Ray Ray says hail Comicsgate. Black Angus Review says, never cave like your boy Hack. Wow. I would never cave, but I do get comfortable. Understand, like, you know, I was talking, like I said, in this conversation with my wife and my dad upstairs, I was like, I was scared. I'm not scared anymore. Like, I'm feeling, like, that's, fear is like a big motivation, like, to build something. Uncertainty pushes you forward to making something new. But I feel great right now, so, it's like, getting me to make like a convention, but let's do it. I'm going to do it because I'm angry. Anger is also equally important. Harley Kitten says, is it too late or possible to rent a banquet room on the same day so fans can come and see you guys? We talked about that last night. My feeling is this, fuck Chicago. Chicago is a hellhole anyway. It's run by Democrats. And we would be pumping money into the city at a point when C2E2 is, and so they would appreciate it. Like, you know, all the local businesses are excited about C2E2 because, you know, they're going to get money because of people who are there. I don't want to give them any money. I don't want to give any Democrat city money like that when they've just kicked me out. I'll still give Philly some money because they have the Philadelphia Phillies. I would like to give my money to any conservative state or city instead. So I'm not interested. I'm not interested. I don't think we should do it. I don't. And I think some people are going to do it. John and Shane are probably going to do it. I just think it's a mistake and we need to refocus our energies somewhere else. Yak the Culture says, what about your very own Trash Con? We can have an ISOM cosplayer contest. As cosplayer dunking boot. Roberto Irizarry says, Ripaverse will no longer get my money. Bros before Hosey. Harley Kitten says, thanks for having the integrity to stand by your friends, especially for what you and the chat did for Cody. Rock Crin, new member, thanks for joining. Base Bunny Love says, I'd rather see you at a con than go to Planet Fitness locker room. 200 Watt Studio says, for the Fans Fest and 5K, I read that one. Abra's 2 cents says, sorry, just joined the chat. Are you still going to Chicago? Main reason I wanted to go was to meet you. Abra's, I don't think I'm going to go. I think it's a mistake to go. I think it sends a... I think it's a surrender to go. I don't want to surrender. Okay? We got pushed out. I don't want to still go there. I want to... Instead, I want to choose a nice conservative state, someplace that we can all agree to, someplace that's kind of fun, and host an actual mini convention there. Same thing we wanted to do. And it wouldn't be hard, guys. You know, it wouldn't be hard to do this. We could actually just, build a convention, just a small convention. They have conventions like this all the time. They're just little hotel room, banquet halls. People set up their stuff. We get a few retailers who are interested. We appear there as the talent. We could do live streams from the convention. Like, we could have a table and do kind of a live stream. You could come and we'll see, like, how it goes. We got to start somewhere. The thing is, like, we don't know how big it would be or how small it would be. We have no clear idea of what it would be. So we want to just think about a small meetup or get together in a hotel room, ballroom, and just make the festivities great, make it fun, do our own thing, get a few retailers to set up, like people to sell comics. All creators would be welcome. And then we actually keep our money, the money that we spend at restaurants and, stuff like that stays in a place that actually appreciates and wants our business. Why would we want to force our money on a city that doesn't want our business? They don't want us there. It's clear. Travis Parrott says, big middle fingers to C2E2. Good morning, E. Thank you, Travis Parrott. FB says, happy Easter all. Christos Sinesti. Repairman Jack. I'm curious, if they hadn't put Ethan and John's name on the website, do you think they would have got canceled? I don't know. When I saw that they did that, I was like, this is really ballsy. Like, this is incredible. Like, if this works from here, like, it's clear things have changed in the comic book industry for the better, but I knew. Keen Scene, thanks for being a member for 41 months, but some of your fans have already put money into seeing you all in Chicago. I know. I understand that. Sorry about that. Super Wacky, I would be there. You understand? Super Wacky Wabbit says, CG Con Winnipeg, Manitoba. 200 Watts Studio says, call Biggins to see if Vegas is still on. Vegas never officially scheduled. They just talked about it. But they never really put it on for some reason. I don't know why. Yeah, I'm just not into it. I don't want to go any place. I don't want to support them. I love boycotts. Even if it's just me doing the boycott, I choose where to spend my money. I do not use Kickstarter, for example. You know, I do not use Disney. Still, I almost decided to take Ava. Ava has not mentioned Disney in a while. I'm not bringing it up to her. I don't want to go to Disney. I don't want to. I think it would be a big mistake. No Disney World. What else am I boycotting? Bud Light is a boycott, but on the other hand, I never drank Bud Light anyway. It's not really a boycott for me. Ethan B. for boycotting Van Sciver. Coffee's Hunter says, it wouldn't be hard to do. You've been talking about doing a convention for about 6 years now. Yeah, I know. And I just, the thing about me doing the convention is it's me doing the convention. It's me doing the convention. Everybody talks about it and, like, you go, can I have some help? Does anybody want to help in any way? Nobody's there to help. Nobody wants to help. I got to do it. It's got to be me. I know now. Everybody else, they'll go to conventions, but actually building a convention of our own and making something new, if I want it to happen, it has to be me. I got to do it. It's got to be my job. Why So Serious says, we'd still love to see you in Chicago, even if you don't go to the con, but it's completely understandable since they've destroyed a once beautiful city. Geek Getaway says, don't blame the city for C2E2 being soft. Chicago still loves Comicsgate. What should I do with all these pies I bought to give you live on stream? Eat them. Headrock says, this is sour grapes. Should never have agreed. It's totally sour grapes. Headrock, I want you to know, I acknowledge that. It really is. It is the literal definition of sour grapes. But what are you going to do? You know, it's like they made an agreement with us. It's like we made an agreement with them. No, it isn't sour grapes, because we made an agreement with them and they agreed to it. And we said, wow, maybe this is good. Maybe everything's good. And then suddenly they rescinded. So it's like, it's not as though, it's like they made themselves seem like they were going to do business with us. And then they fucked us over. When you dislike somebody for fucking you over and you realize that organization sucks, like, is that sour grapes? I mean, I don't think so. I think it's a lesson learned. Sour grapes become wine, says David Borland. Headrock says, why trust their agreement is my point. I understand that completely, but because they're not supposed to be Mark Brooks. They're supposed to be C2E2. They're supposed to be a big convention. They should have a little bit more integrity than that. That's what I think. All right. Anyway, so that's kind of all I really want to say about that. Do you guys want to talk about him more? Chicago is a hellhole. F Chicago. Headrock says, supposed. Headrock, what do you want from me? You're preaching to the choir here. I agree with you. It's just the way it is. I want to meet you guys. I want to meet you guys. I do not want to meet you guys in a way where we're funding the enemy. I just don't want to. And if those people were good enough to just stand by their agreement with us and treat us, you know, with respect and not politically discriminate against us, I would do that. I'd give them our money. But they're not like that. They are exactly like what we suspected they were. So I don't want to. Okay, lesson learned. It's like you think that after a few years things are going to change, but they don't. They haven't changed. And that's just kind of the way it is. Gen X Catholic says, become the Comics Gate Nick Fuentes. Well, I mean, Tom Tuttle says, my kind of town, Chicago ain't. Does Shane still hate Cecil? Yes. I think so. I think that's clear. All right, hold on a second. Timmy Mello says, happy Easter, CG. Ethan and House Van Skyver, it's situations like these. It's a blessing in disguise. This is a surefire way to get a true CG con running. Yeah, I agree. I agree with that. I think it's a nice motivation. So coming to Morris Town, I'm 2 minutes from it. Yes, I will be at Garden State Comic Fest in June. I will be there. That's a commitment. They're really good. I told them, look, I'll come, but like, you know, you can't get me canceled, and they're good about that. Dioberg says, C2E2 sold your tables to Ed Fiskor. I'm sure Ed Fiskor is still welcome. And that's the way that is. Why is John Malin claiming a pizza contest win? Says St. Patrick T. I don't know, Patrick. Like, you ate that pizza so fast, it didn't even seem normal. Like, you really, you're good at eating pizza. I got to give it to you. Like, unless there was an illusion. You're like a magician. You're like a stage magician with that pizza. But clearly, no one's been able to prove shenanigans. So you got the win. I think people were just like, how did he eat that whole pizza in 2 minutes? Very thin pizza for Patrick. Patrick's pizza was thin crust. Patrick ate the thinnest crusted pizza in the world. He's disqualified. Now, there it is, Patrick. I mean, that's why people are saying, you know, that you might be disqualified from it. He says that's bullshit. I don't know. Patrick, I'm with you. I saw you eat a pizza. And I had trouble. I ate 3 slices. I really felt sick and I felt angry. And Anna, like, I was angry eating that pizza. Anna ate most of her pizza and then like passed out in a diabetic coma. I've never seen anything like that either. That was crazy. There was no crust requirement in the rule, says Brian 999. Yeah, not that I saw. Thin crispy pizza, not doughy, easy to eat. Yeah, I should have done that. Sounds like crust cope, says Rover. I'm not denying him anything. I'm saying he to me, I think he won. $20 from Anchorfist says, wait, I was away for a minute. Are you guys saying you were kicked from C2E2? I already dropped over $2,000 on a hotel and VIP passes for my wife, my brother, and myself to meet you guys. The fuck, I'm pissed. Anchorfist, here's what's going on, man. We were kicked from the show viciously. And if I were you, I would demand a refund and I would let them know why. Because, that is not cool. I mean, it's one thing for us. It's another thing for you, the fans, you know, who were already planning to be there. I don't know what to say about it. Of course, I'm angry. It's just, you know, why, you know, what is Comicsgate? Why is Comicsgate? This is why Comicsgate's a thing. This is why we exist, because of this. I have done a couple of things. I mean, I've contacted the Comic Book Legal Defense Fund, which should be able to handle something or make a statement or do something. They would be the people to get involved with something like this. Comic Book Legal Defense Fund takes very unpopular stances in comics all the time. And, you know, this would be an unpopular stance, but if they have any integrity at all, you know, that's what... let me see. Got a free member chat, so of course I decided to complain. Your boys finally sent software yesterday after 3 weeks of nagging. Might get it in September. Rolling your eyes. Headrock, what the hell? They did? Oh, you know why? Okay, yeah, because they did. I'm like, how did they send you? They did all the emails yesterday. So I guess that's why. Yes, that's why I should go, says the long lad. This is discrimination. Yes, it is. Looks like I'm doing something else in April. Maybe I'll go to Talladega instead. Well, that's where I will be. I will be in Talladega, and I didn't know that Dover was actually Dover, Delaware, which is an hour from my house. So I'm going to go to both races. I will be at both of Cody's races. And if you want to come actually meet me, if you want to meet me, I'll be in Talladega and I will be at Dover for both of the Camelot races. Should be fun. sorry, what is this world coming to? Says Rinesh Sunarain. This is the way it's been. This is why Comicsgate exists. This is why. Well, this is what's going on. You know, it's like, again, your boy Zach. Got kicked from Kickstarter with John Malin. They you know, took his campaign down. He had a publishing deal with Antarctic Press, and Mark Waid interfered with it and got it canceled. He threatened the guy. I mean, it's like, you know. So this is just more of the same. It's more of the same. Okay, let's move on. I don't want to talk about this endlessly. It is what it is, and it is actually probably a blessing in disguise. Let's talk about something more fun. Let's talk about the ISOM concept art book. Oh, my God. Here it is, guys. I'm very excited about this. Let me open these in new tabs so we can get a better look at them. This is what we need to do. We need to examine the ISOM book. And just talk about it. We're going to do some commentary. This is all for the purpose of review. And that's why we're going to look at least the first four pages. Oh, God, there's more. it's an eight-page book. Now, we actually watched a video together a little while ago of an individual who had purchased this. And he was very upset about it. Like, he did not seem happy. He seemed, the look on his face, the look on this poor gentleman's face as he reviewed his purchase. This was part of the first ISOM campaign. The first ISOM campaign raised an awful lot of money, $3.7 million. And it did so largely because the prices... there are a couple of things. One of the things that we always mention is, you know, Eric's got a big audience. True. But also, the prices for his quote-unquote products are just way out of line. Way out of line. And nobody was paying attention because people just wanted to support him, give him money. I don't think anybody went through this with any degree of shrewdness. And thought, like, what is this actually worth? Why am I paying this much money for this comic book? What exactly is an original concept art book? What am I expecting here? What am I going to get for $75? Paul Schlock says, but it sold for $300 on eBay now. Truly a great investment. Yeah, that's right. Somebody bought it. What, a detractor bought it to take it apart. The guy who scanned this is the guy who bought the book for $300. He scanned it. He wanted to show people what it was. So he figured it was worth $300. For some reason, I don't know whether to laugh or cry about that. It's like, oh my God, like it's $75 for an 8-page book. Yes, but somebody just bought one for $300. Yes, but the person who bought it was a detractor who just wanted to take it apart and make fun of it on the internet. I mean, is it worth it? How much would you pay to make fun of the Ripaverse? let me see. Torvaldsen says ISOM stands for I Shit Out Mediocrity. Headrock says, why? For laughs. Some people have $300 to kill, I guess. That's just the way it is. But it's funny because, yes, this is true. Fotrius Pyrilus. Maybe next time Eric sells one, he'll charge $300 for it. I'd like to see that. Well, that's the way he thinks. He goes, wait a second. You mean these are commanding $300? Well, that's what I should be charging for it then. Eric lied about the limited numbers on cover A and B for ISOM, tricking customers. Yeah. Eric got none of that $300, says Johnny D. Well, that's something that he's got to fix. In the future, when he does another art book, he's got to charge $300 for it. And there will be people who pay it. Billy Bax goes here. He says, $9.99 Yaira box set is effing stupid. You know what's the most stupid thing about it? Is the price tag of $9.99. Because, I mean, Eric is like, you know what? They're going to see $1,000 and they're going to be scared. Like, this is like the classic kind of pricing scam. 99 cents, it's less than a dollar, so it doesn't look like very much money. $9.99 is $1 less than $1,000, so it doesn't look like $1,000. That's marketing. If I were you guys, I would learn economics and marketing. But it's incredible because it's so blatantly obvious that he's trying to manipulate and deceive like his audience that he would use a $9.99. Just put $1,000, Eric. Nothing else is priced that way. Is it? Are things priced $29.99 and things like that on your campaign? $9.99. It gives me a headache right here. This is by far more insulting than anything else I've seen in the indie comic scene. Well, you ain't seen nothing yet. Eros World says, there you are. Have you recovered from your pizza coma? Also, where is my The Complete Story offer you promised? The money's burning a hole in my pocket, pie man. Yeah, we'll have it for Easter tomorrow. I have the... What I want to do is I want to make sure that I have enough of something that is the same. So I got Blood Honey. I got 1998. I'm ready for that. And I need 100 copies of Wreck Planet, the same one. So I want to make sure I have 100 of something, whether it's the Roquefort cover or Kelsey Shannon's American Hopper cover. And then just make sure I have 100 Salamandroid Death Stings. And I might throw in some other stuff too, but we'll do a complete story package in a folder and then a variant version that's in a magnetic box. For Easter. It'll be a really, really nice special. Let me double check and let me make sure I have the right quantities of everything. Because I'd like to offer 100 of them. And they will sell through. They'll definitely sell through. I want to offer 100 of them at a good price. And I have to make sure I have the content. $37.50 per page. That's what he paid. And is it worth it? I will find out. $666 should have been the dollar should have been the Saskas box set. Eros World. Okay, I read that one. Thank you very much for that. I appreciate that big super chat. Biden just declared that Easter Sunday is Trans Visibility Day, says Jim Satala. Are you joking? He is mocking all Christians. C2E2 has pulled a Judas move. Bring on the asteroid or at least sue them and find out who did this. Yeah. We'll see. We'll see what gets advised to us. I don't know. That's real. Transvisibility Day is on Easter. Trans or invisibility. Wouldn't you, if you were trans, wouldn't you want to be passing? Why would you want to be visible? We could see. Yeah, we could see that you're a man. We can see that you're a man in the little girl's room, shaving. Visibly grotesque. I'm not joking, says Jim Satala. Absolutely disgusting. But we got a chance, guys. I'm telling you, we live in an inside-out clown world of hostile, evil leftists who have utter power and want to wield it to destroy American society. And I don't know. We got to do something about it. We have an election this year. I hope we can win. I hope Trump wins. I hope we can do it. A tea and toys. 10 pounds. Thank you. Isom is gay. looking forward to Rainbow the Brute toys. Thoughts on an evil parody of the Get Along Gang, the We Hate You crew, led by Mad Moose, hired by the undefeated Unbearables for Rainbow Brute 2. I love it. Get Along Gang would be great. But the thing about Get Along Gang is they weren't exclusively for girls. They were kind of like unisex. You know, the Smurfs are the same way. The Smurfs were not exclusively for girls either, but they're in this. So the Get Along Gang could be in there too. And Shirt Tales, you know, a bunch of those shitty cartoons from the 80s. Yeah, that's funny, dude. Maybe we'll do it. Rainbow Brood toys are going to happen pretty soon. I need to fulfill Snowman. People are asking when I'm going to launch these campaigns. When Snowman is fulfilled, when it's underway at least, with fulfillment, that's when we will launch Fearsome and Rainbow the Brute. Also, I did get the pricing for the cars, which is good. The cars aren't even due to come in until Christmas, but I'll probably get them out sooner than that because it shouldn't take that long. I got the car. You know, the thing about it is that you have to, let me see, open this up in a new tab. When it comes to making these cars, you have to just kind of choose a car. They already have cars that are ready to go. And we tried to get the closest approximation to like a NASCAR to use for these die-cast miniature cars and then put the Cyberfrog thing on. So we ended up getting this right here. This is the car that we got. Don't worry about the paint job on it right now. The paint job doesn't matter. This is going to be the car that we're going to use to put Cody's Cyberfrog wrap on it. This is the miniature, the die-cast miniature that you all ordered. We've selected the right one. This is the one that we're going to use. I hope it's good enough. That you can get these cars like already pre-made and everything like that and just put a wrap over them. So this is about as good as we can get. Without getting sued by NASCAR. So yeah, that's gonna be the thing. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, hold on. Let me catch up with a couple more super chats and then we're going to get into this. Please keep For the Fans Fest in Florida for the international flights. Yeah, I want to go to Florida. You should definitely go to Chicago with Shane and John. Fans paid, planned and paid for at least the chance to hang with you guys. I understand that, Chuck. But it's a mistake. It's a mistake to go there. It's just a mistake. I don't want to pour any money into that place. Well, we're gonna get... If we go there, you know how embarrassing it is? That we would be going to Chicago and we would be sidelined to meet up like outside of the con. Like we'd probably get thrown out of the con if we go in there and they see us. That's embarrassing. I don't want to do that. That makes me angry. I don't want to be a part of that. I would not enjoy that. I would be angry to be there. EVS, how much would you pay to make fun of the Ripaverse? Me, precisely 15 sums. Isom is gay. Matt Grendel says, line all the trans people up so we can see them for visibility. Yeah. Son of Liberty Radio says, I have a hard copy of that concept art book. EVS, $299 free shipping. You can write on it and auction it. No, thank you. Yeah, I don't want one. But I'm glad that Tiso purchased this for us so that we can check it out. All right, so here we go. This is the book. Eric July, he wrote Narration. Is he retarded? Like, Narration? Is this an audiobook? Juice Cannon, thanks for gifting one membership. Am I wrong about this? That's silly. Hold on a second. Libtards are emboldened now from their win at C2E2. They're going to keep pushing and push her harder to get ARCA NASCAR and Talladega to ban your car, Ray. Well, I think it's too late for that. But, I mean, yeah, that's what they do. You know, these wins. See, my attitude about the, like, when they win like this is to keep it quiet. But we can't keep this quiet. You want to keep it quiet because you don't want to encourage them to do more of this. I don't know. That's why you don't put yourself in this. I fucking kick myself. Brett says, I got a guy in Florida who can make a con happen. You know him. I will see him today and see if he will hit you up. Brett, thank you. Yeah, tell him to hit me up about that. Narration. Marcos Rios, concept artist, and Eric Weathers. Eric Weathers, by the way, as of today, is officially exclusive to All Caps Comics. He will no longer be working for Ripaverse. Today was his last day. Yesterday was his last day. Today is his first day. Eric Weathers is no longer lettering or doing anything for Ripaverse. He was the guy who was putting together all the emails. He was doing all the design work. He is now exclusive to All Caps Comics, although Eric Weathers will also be allowed to work for anyone other than the Ripaverse. He can go ahead and work for anyone who is Comicsgate. Just the same way, the Comicsgate trademark is available. Just ask me for people who want to use it because I'm protecting it. Eric Weathers is also available for hire to anyone who is Comicsgate who would like a letterer. So nothing has really changed. It's just that he is, he's exclusive to All Caps, and he will not be working for Ripaverse anymore. And he has his own reasons for that, but Easter Sunday, a very nice, the weekend of Easter is a very, it's a good symbolic time for Eric Weathers to have left Ripaverse. Sean Connery versus Applesauce says you should brand him like they do in Yellowstone. I will start branding my exclusive employee. Eric is my first employee now, like my first employee that doesn't pack books up. So I will put him to work not only lettering this stuff, but also he's going to be using my email list to produce, updates. I'm going to have him do all the updates for campaigns, et cetera, et cetera. Create cool, promotional stuff like he was doing for them. It'll be good. Eric Weathers working for me, making a little more money too. Andy Montemayor says, Eric will just say he wasn't shit anyway. Eric Weathers is the best letterer in the world. He's really, really good. So hooray. Hey, guess what? It's time to praise the sun, says Baneling in the Shadows. Thanks for streaming in the night, Pie Man. I mean night for me, not you. Yeah. My pleasure. Sheeple Hunter says, yeah, you draw 10 pages a year. Not much work. 10 pages a year. I wish. Let's see the first page here. Avery Silman. Now, when Eric July first approached me about this, he said, look, I'm writing the book right now. And I said, oh, can I see your character? And he sent me over these drawings here. And I remember seeing these and just being like, bro. Oof. I remember saying, bro. So this is it? Like, this is, then he gets his real costume, right? Like, this is just his, like, what is it? Like, a starter costume? He said, no, this is him. I said, what's his name? He said, Isom. I said, yeah, but what's his superhero name? He said, that is his superhero name. What's the name of the book? The book's called Isom. What? To me, at the time, it sounded like some fucking Muslim shit, and I didn't want to get into it, because I don't know what Eric July's faith is. I really had no idea, but Isom sounded pretty Muslim to me, and the whole thing looked Muslim, looked like Islam, and I just kind of left it there. I was like, this is, like, not good, man. And I didn't sign an NDA over this or anything, so I did show Anna. at the time. And Anna's comments, you know, were, you know, reasonable, I thought, you know. People who saw this were kind of like, this is underwhelming. I said, yeah, I don't know. Oh, maybe it's going to be good, though. Who knows? Avery Silman, a.k.a. Ice Tom. Ice Tom was the first character that I created for Ripaverse Comics. Oh, my God. I went in with the intention of creating someone that I had the utmost confidence in, because this is the character that would be the primary focus for when the company launched. EVS, how come you can't make an art book this good? That's a great question. Well, maybe now I can, because Eric Weathers works for me. Looks like a junior high school kid making a fan page for Who's Who. Yeah, it sounds like it too. It reads like it. For Christmas this year, I want a Red Ryder BB gun with a compass and a stock and a thing which tells time. I don't think a football is a very good football Christmas present. I don't think that a football is a very good Christmas present. Richard Cahill says, look into a big Cyberfrog billboard. We'd love to see it. Islam says, Pranbhat Gulati. Yeah, that's like how I felt about it. The whole thing kind of gave me the creeps. Like the way the character looked and everything in the name gave me the creeps. Reading the SJW voice, says Juice Cannon. I don't want to, because that's not Eric. Like, Eric doesn't have an SJW voice. He's got a simple voice. Oh, this would be cool to narrate, though. I miss the days where football was a great present. We miss those days, says Nexus Video. Bosch Faustin's here. He says, Comic Book Legal Defense Fund left me off its Cartoonist Under Fire issue, knowing I was literally under fire from jihadists who were killed before they killed over Motoons. So we shouldn't expect much, huh, Bosch? Bosch, I go through all of this expecting zero. I don't expect anything from these people except for torment and abuse. I don't expect anything fair. I don't expect to be treated fair. I don't expect anything other than, like, rank hypocrisy and stupidity. That's all I expect from them. And I'm not disappointed. You know, I don't care. Like, I ultimately don't care too much. It is motivating, because it's like, oh, so if, Bosch, if I don't make my own convention, there isn't going to be a convention, is there? So you need to, I'm going to invite you. I want you to come too. Show up to this thing. Have some fun. Pranbhat Gulati gives 50 memberships. Thank you very much. I don't expect to get super chats this time in the morning for some reason, because nobody's drunk, but then again, like, on the other side of the world, they're drunk because it's, like, nighttime. So I'll start to get some big foreign international super chats from drunks from Europe. Thank you so much. And from Asia. Daniel says, any chance of a box or a folder for CG Arena? Oh. Well, so far we only have the one book and we're working on Hellephant. So we've got two books. We've got two books coming. A box or a folder. Let's get some more books done. I appreciate it. Yeah. All right, anyway. What the hell are we talking about? The first thing I did was type out how I envisioned Isom as well as his background. Eric cannot write, dude. This was a method I followed with most of the characters. But first thing I did was type out how I envisioned Isom as well as his background. This was a method I followed with most of the characters. There's no way he wrote the book. But the unique thing about Isom was that I drew a sketch of his face and suit before I sent it to Marcos. I even colored the suit on a tablet. The truth is, I wanted Marcos to have as many reference points as possible, even though my sketch was terrible. He did a fantastic job of bringing it to life. You don't see a lot of heroes with this color scheme. The X-Men. Oh, you mean black? Third grade level writing, says Element 47. Yeah, or fifth grader. Yeah, this is dumb. He fooled a lot of people into thinking he was really intelligent, but Eric is dumb. Low IQ. How can he say, like, this, like, there isn't very much, you know, with this color scheme? That's the X-Men. It's also my all caps comics colors. What else is this? It's Luke Cage. Oh, fuck it. You're right. It's Luke Cage Power Man. He literally copied Luke Cage. And then he said, I don't know. It's really unique. How is this a thing? I like calling ethnics a color scheme. Ethnics. Oh, God. Yeah. I had some, like, in-laws, extended in-laws from my previous marriage who would call them element. They'd say, there's not a lot of element, is there, where we're going? Which meant people of color. they were Jews. The people who used phrases like element. There's not a lot of element in this neighborhood, is there? Element. Gene Wood says, only a matter of time before Eric claims the title of raconteur. Oh, that'd be amazing if Eric was just like, started to see himself as kind of like, you know, one of the guests on Match Game 73. You know, just somebody who could roll with that. Eric July on a roasting dais as one of the roasters. AKA Pat says, Ayo, that ice I'm running post is a Cap Garney swipe. Like, oh, yeah. I tagged you in a tweet, X for comparison. Yeah, I noticed that. Of course it is. But then again, also, like, it's just... Wait, I just noticed something. Hold on a second. Mask? He's running. There he is. But you know what? Mask? Question mark? Should we give him a little fucking, like, a little Hamburglar mask? That is funny, dude. Juan Wong says, Dear Ethan, I'm here in Australia at 3 a.m. I thought I needed to poop. I was wrong. Can't sleep. Listening to Trash Cast. Juan Wong, you're welcome. Glad you're tuning in. I love the little mask. Does he need a, like, Ravel. Does he need a little Burger King mask? What was he called? The Hamburglar? Oh, yeah. That makes all the difference. Based art department series says, will For the Fans Fest include the Liam Grave fight? Yeah, if he's open to it, sure. We would have to go someplace where that would be legal. That is orangey. A low saturation, but orange. Well, my bad then. It looks like a amber yellow. I love the question mark. Should we put a mask on him? $75 well spent. Yeah, this is like, really, you know, it's a great opportunity to see behind the scenes, like the creative process. The creative process at work here. You got a, you know, this is a Eric July talking about how he created ISOM, and then you get to see that Marcos, his friend, who he only calls by a first name, Marcus Rios, though, he brought it to life. Wait, he did a fantastic job of bringing it to life. This is a fantastic job. Fantastic is a word that gets used a lot now. I wanted to see it defined. What does it mean? Extraordinarily good or attractive. Extraordinarily good. Tremendous. Remarkable. Great. Enormous. Terrific. Fantastic. Good job. Yeah, I don't know why he didn't use the domino mask. Wandering CG King Marduk Knight says, Hey, greetings from Concrete Mulvania. Much love. Same to you. What's up, man? Sir Patrick T says, I like real orange. Yeah, I don't like this fake orange. I like Liam Gray style orange. Yeah. Variant, $75, guys. The inner workings of how to make a comic book. You know what? Like, I don't even know if I like this because I don't want to see behind the screens. I don't want to see behind the curtain. I mean, you know what I mean? Sometimes I'm just like, let me sit back and just enjoy the magic show that is Isom and Ripaverse. Do you want to see you want to know how the trick is done? I don't know if I do. I prefer to believe in fantastic magic like this. You know, don't take away all of the intrigue, all the mystery and wonder. Eros World says, Ice, I'm the masked turd burglar. What the hell? Leon K says, YouTube app round super chats down to 99 cents for some reason. Did you know you have 180 pies to eat for Cody's race perks? Have a blessed Easter. Yeah, I know. 180 pies. Christine Venner says, how can I get a copy of Amphibionics number one? I have number two, but not number one. Christine, it is part of, if you go to eBay, let me show you if I can find it real quick. It's fantastic. Oh, look at this. As a matter of fact, maybe go here. CyberFrog Spring Package right here. Five comics for $25 has Amphibionics number one and number two for just $25. This is a really, really good deal. It is CyberFrog Spring right now. It was Yaira Winter, but it isn't anymore. It is CyberFrog Spring. You can get five CyberFrog comic books for $25 right here. And I've made 200 of these packages available. We've sold 88 of them. There are still 112. So you can definitely get one of these sets of comics. That's awesome. $25 for five comic books. You know, Eric July is selling like 1/16th of a comic book for $75, which I think this is a better deal. And our comic books are good. If you really think about it, like, our comic books are good and his are bad, and they don't cost nearly as much. Here's Parody. He says, this makes me feel like I'm part of a team. Like, I'm right here with them, choosing which 3D assets to use in the scene. I know, isn't it great? Like, it really puts you, like, in the driver's seat. Mr. Key says, messaging you this from this side of the world. Messaging you from this side of the world. When most celebrate, people like me work. Happy Easter, Ethan, and hail CG. Thank you, Mr. Keys. Thank you so much for $10. I appreciate that. From whatever side of the world you're on. Sinfected said, just got mine delivered. Thank you, EVS. That's not cheap. It's good value, says Harold of War. Yeah, it really is. And Sinfected got his. What's a color zine? Says Ravine 2112. Hey, Hunter. How you doing? You want to say hello? Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm just grabbing some tools. I left the tool here.
Are you going with us today?
Yeah, probably. Hope so.
Okay, we're leaving at 2. So you got to be here at 2 to get in the car to get a ride with us.
Please, sir, come pick me up.
I have to. Why? When you're already here.
You offered to.
I know, but I didn't think you would come here. You're here.
I'm coming to pick up tools. I'm working on cars right now. I got to get done before I go.
All right.
Love you.
I love you too, buddy. Hey, Hunter, everybody says.
Hello.
Yeah, we got an extra ticket to the Phillies game, and I told Hunter he could go if he was feeling okay. He wasn't feeling so good. And he said, I got to fix a couple of cars, and we'll see like how things are before then. I said, well, we'll come by. Like, we're leaving at 2. We'll come by your place at 2:30 to pick you up. And then here he is at the house. It's like, I got to go there anyway now. I don't want to drive to his house, but we will. We're going to do it. We'll pick him up. Father and son, three generations of Van Skyvers going to the Phillies today. After they lost yesterday, you want to give them a shot again? Yeah. I know. Yeah. They always start out slow. Phillies always have a bad, like, opener. But by June, they're going to be winning, and they'll get ahead. So, you know, we'll get there. I'm like off in space. This is one way to do it. Anyway, this orange cover here is Amphibionics number one. This is actually a deep orange. You can see a nun on CyberFrog shoulder blades. There's one other place that you can get it where you can just get Amphibionics one and 1998 Diary of Heather Swain, but that's also $25. So it really doesn't make sense. Get this instead. What is Salamandroid Color Zine? It is the first appearance of Salamandroid in color, okay, because it was in black and white. And then it's also Harris Comics said, we want to own that. We'll buy the pages and we'll reprint them, but make it about cyber fraud. So I took those pages and I added a couple more. And then, you know, that was reprinted as Salamandroid Zine by Harris Comics. It's that too, repeated, recolored. So it's that's what it is. It's all the early Salamandroid black and white material in color for the first time. Just to have that stuff. I wanted all my black and white work to be in color. You know, so that's what it is. All right, anyway, let's get back to Isom. As soon as Marco sent me back the concept art, it really set in stone our relationship because of how good it was. What? What is this? It set in stone our relationship. Are you having a gay affair with the guy who drew this? Well, if you were, it would explain why you used it. Because this is like, this isn't good, Eric. It's set in stone because of how good it was. How good what was? That dick? What is this? What is this, dude? It's a love that lasts forever. Man, this is weird. I might have to use the SJW voice. Hold on a second. I'll be right back. no, I had to get my water. It was obvious that he gets, in quotes, it. He's getting it, Eric? This is weird, man. This is really, really weird. Hold on a second. Let me read this again. As soon as Marcus sent back the concept art, it really set in stone our relationship because of how good it was. It was obvious that he gets it. And I hope to have him on our team for many years. I can't wait for the world to read his origin story because I feel it's something very special. Isom was the first character we worked on, but not the first thing pertaining to Ripaverse we created concept art for. I first conceptualized the city of Florist Park, Texas, and other locations of interest, such as Isom's ranch, which I also provided Marcus a terrible sketch of. And he returned the favor. He gets it. It is. This is terrible, dude. Oh, my God. What is this? Oh, boy. Look at skin. Oh, my God. I like the color swatches here. This is what you do. You do color swatches like this for toys, you know. Because it's like, this paint color, please. I've never really seen it done for comics, but maybe that's what happens. I've never seen this, dude. This is great. Why didn't he include the Eric sketches? I don't know, Super Tiso. Seems like a disappointment to me. Can you bundle Cyberfrog 1 and Cyberfrog 2 Chromium covers? Double shipping to Amsterdam is killing me. Nazaro, yeah, just go ahead and say, can you please refund the extra shipping? What we do is if you buy a bunch of things from our eBay store or just two things, pay the shipping, they'll put the package together, they'll weigh it, they'll print out the label, and then you will be refunded the excess shipping costs, okay? So just put in a note asking for Mikey to do that. He will do that for you. And thank you for your support. We appreciate you. Generic woke black woman. Wow. I like that it's it's her head from one side and then the other side. And then in the middle. And then like that skin tone. And they're like, how many different skin tones are there here? What is this? How come there are four different skin tones? And then hair tone. And then suit tone. Whoever did this, like... Oh. Look at it. just leaning up against the wall with a weird knee. Looking at your iPhone. Boy, it really... This is how comics are made, guys. I really wish like I wasn't seeing this because it really is kind of like it's making the magic kind of disappear a little bit for me. She has goat legs, says MPC, Oasis. oh my goodness. Her blackness rating. Yeah. This is these are the three different colors that I guess you could choose from. I don't get it. I don't understand why. I don't understand why this is a thing, but it's pretty funny. You know what? You can leave the color. You can leave it up to the colorist. You really can. I don't. You don't need to put swatches down for color, especially not for skin tone. It really does seem kind of weird and kind of like focused on skin color, which shouldn't be a focus. I mean, it shouldn't be a focus, should it? Or is it? Black girl magic achieved. Says Sector Respector. Gray is a skin tone? Yeah, what is that? That's like putty. Putty skin tone. oh my goodness. Oh, you know what it is? That skin tone is the highlight used under her chin. If you look, this light like putty color... Right here is the highlight under her chin. It's only used here and then on her eyelid here and then on her ear. And, you know, suspiciously right underneath the collarbone. Look at her little arm, her little T-Rex arm looking at her iPhone miserably. Like freaking bigots. Trying to get into C2E2, are you? We'll see about that. Hello, C2E2. This is Altoona. Did you know that there are some bigots and racists that are trying to get a table at C2E2? Wow, so that's how it happened. Nice big knobby knee here. Altoona Silman. Oh, support characters are arguably just as important to develop as the main ones. Creating Isom marked the creation of my universe Bible. Universe Bible. In which I document everything for continuity purposes. I came up with a brief family tree. And quick background for Avery and his family. It's a lot of work for like unnecessary work for a book that made very, very little sense. The Universe Bible. Oh my God, dude. Universe Bible, probably six pages, says Paul Schlock. Oh, this is really funny. This is when I figured that his sister, Altoona, would be introduced in the first book and have an important role. She needed an interesting backstory of her own. I tied her to the biotech company Progexis because that could create some interesting storylines going into the future. In a world with super beings, the people without powers are more challenging to create, and you really must focus on their development. I modeled Altoona slightly after my cousin, and then Marcos did the final concept art. This is your cousin? Sup, cuz? Hell yeah. One of the most important things to come from Altona's creation is her daughter, Vassy. That's important. One of the most important things to come from Altona's creation is a different character. Am I in hell? I feel like I might be in hell. Any new puppet shows? It's about Patrick Day. If there is one, it'll premiere tonight or tomorrow. Terrible sentence structure, says Infected. I agree. It was terrible. How come Vassy didn't get a page here, too? I don't know. Okay, here we go. Oh, my God. Yaira. Oh, this is where the kind of workout costume. You're not putting enough emphasis on the T's, said Davis, David G. Yeah, I agree with you. Yes, Ethan, you are in hell, says Simon Wild. I mean, this feels like hell. I feel like I'm in purgatory. Suffering for crimes against SJWs and social justice. Hey, Ethan, because you fought back against SJWs, we're going to send you to this weird amateurish hell in which everyone around you is making comics and they're retarded and they hate you. Okay. None of them have any idea about storytelling. They just know about business. And they want to destroy you. Oh, okay. And you got to sit there and look at this stuff and just, it's like, it's high budget, like super high budget, super low intelligence, super low IQ, super incompetent shit. This is hell. This is what hell is, I'm pretty sure, for a comic book creator. Eros World says, Eric wrote a Bible. He truly is Black Jesus. ridiculous. You look like you're in bingitory, says... purgatory and bingitory, says Cody. Yes, that's funny. Thank you for that. At least you guys are funny. At least if I'm in hell with retards, I'm also here with you guys who are smart and funny. Period says, has anybody said that you do the perfect impression of Wallace Shawn, who is Grand Nagus from DS9, and Inconceivable Guy from Princess Bride? Oh, yeah. Inconceivable! Yeah, I guess so. Jamie Max says, we're retards too. No, I don't think so. Some of you are. Who actually did this art? I can do better and I suck. Will you look at her? Look at her boobies. This is SJW art. With the flat pancake. Like, you don't have to. She doesn't have to look like this. What are you afraid of? You can draw her looking hot. You don't have to draw her looking like Heather Antos. You can draw her looking hot if you want to. You're allowed to. It's your pencil. It's your paper. You could do whatever you want to do. Nostradamus, thanks for $20. Happy Easter to all my fellow fake-ass Christians. Oh, and to you, Ethan. Thank you, Nostradamus. You could do whatever you want to do. You don't have to draw like this. It's infuriating. All right. The intention of ISOM number one was to not just introduce ISOM and his story, but to also serve as a launching pad for an entire universe. So we absolutely had to write a story that made sense so that we could bring in other characters that would play vital roles later. Oh, so you failed. We absolutely had to write a story that made sense. we had to. Yeah, that was our goal. Well, I mean, you know, what are you going to do? Why is life like this? Does John Malin complain about this stuff? Does Shane Davis complain about it, or is it just me? Am I the only one who's complaining about this garbage? I feel like I am. But you guys would know. You guys would tell me. Put this next to the Ms. Marvel comic. It looks the same, really. It does look pretty much the same. What What a nightmare. We absolutely had to do this. We absolutely had. Hold on a second here. I'll get back to it. We absolutely had to write a story that made sense so that we could bring in other characters that would play vital roles later. Yaira was one of the few characters that I created before I wrote the actual story. This is due to the fact that I had great intentions for her, and she'll be a very prominent character of the Ripaverse. After documenting her backstory, I wrote the description of the character. He's so goddamn boring. All of him is boring. Everything that he's doing is boring. This description of how... Dad, how you doing? Come on down. People haven't seen you in a while.
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, I got a live stream going here.
Telephone or something.
No. I'm complaining about Isom. This is Trashcast, Pop.
Is he still an issue?
Well, he's... There's Dad. Hold on a second. Let me pull you. See the people here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going over the Isom. Remember Marvel used to have Marvel Universe magazines? And they were like the guide to Marvel. You'd open them up and it'd be like, oh, here's Spider-Man. And there's a description of him and his first appearance and all that. You know what I mean? Do you remember Marvel Universe?
You're talking to me?
Yes.
I didn't know I was on.
You're right there. You're on.
Oh, look at that.
Carl Manvers versus Gyrar will be the greatest comic book battle in the world. It's a real deal in comic business. It is. It defines the Ripponomics. It is. Says Black Lives or Black Knives. Thanks for being a member for two.
So what are you talking about? Look at that. All these people are saying hi to me. Hello, everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Can they hear me?
Yeah, they can hear you. Yeah.
Okay.
Wonderful.
I just took a nap. I just buzzed out. I woke up. I had my arm around Big Bird.
Yeah. Ava put the Big Bird in your bed.
Help me sleep. I might have to take it back with me.
It's like a teddy bear.
Yeah.
Tom Tuttle says, Hail Holiday.
Thank you. Bless their hearts.
And Dean Shinley says, Holiday is a man of great wisdom and charm. He's a blessing to the world. Ethan, do better.
I need to go down on the field and help the Phillies, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
A little upset. Swinging at pitches they shouldn't be swinging at, son. You know that.
Yeah, I know.
I need to teach them. I don't know what kind of training they're getting down there in the off season, but it's not adequate, obviously.
How was the game last night? Happy Easter, says Brappy Hour.
Oh, wonderful. It was good to be there. You know that? It was good to be in the ballpark, to have so much stuff to look at, all these happy people celebrating, and Wheeler put on a gem.
He did great.
He was so good. And then had to take him out, a little cold there. Don't want to wreck his arm early on. Look at these wonderful people.
Head Rock says, how did such a fat man come out of such a thin man? What kind of thing is that to say to me?
He's not fat.
He's my son. Julian Wong says, missed my super chat, just saying. Let me see, I'll find your super chat here. Frank Castle says, doing a double 24-hour shift at work this weekend, providing IT support. Wanted to say, hey, LCG, you all rock. Thank you. Internet guy for $5 says, this reads like someone trying to hit a word count for a school paper. Hot garbage. It's unbelievable, Dad. You got to see how this guy writes. Julian Wong, I'll find your super chat there. Hold on a second.
What are you criticizing? What's being analyzed here?
Oh, I'll show you in 1 second.
Okay.
People wanted to see you for a minute, and then we'll get back to work with the thing that we're looking at. And you can comment, too. Julian Wong.
Yeah.
Oh, Shane and John aren't surrendering, says Caution Time. They're doing right by their fans. You can do what you want, but that's a wild interpretation of their actions. Julian Wong for $10. My pitch for a Van Sciver Fathers and Son show, Ethan tries to be a good father and son, but always ends up bickering with his dad and Hunter. Curb Your Enthusiasm music while Ethan eats pie. That would be good. Yeah.
Okay.
Here's $100 from Marshall Harrison guitarist. Trash Cash rules. More.
Wow.
$100, dude. Thank you so much. Well, we got to play a little music with that.
Man.
Yeah, here we go. We'll play this. Snoop Dogg. Thank you very much. $100 from Marshall Harrison. Unbelievable.
I have to start one of these things, man. What do you call them? Live streams?
Yeah.
I got to do this.
Isn't that great?
I guess so.
Yeah, it's really nice. People are very nice. Thank you. Yeah.
The air was just so fresh and clean.
In our backyard?
In your back. I went over to look at the job you gave me to do. Yeah, I came here for a little rest and relaxation. All of a sudden, what do you
go ahead and complain, Dad. Now, listen, I'm taking you to baseball. Now, here's all I asked my dad to do. Now, my dad, he went over and he put up drywall for his great-granddaughter. You know, he goes over there, he travels to go. My dad's a carpenter. You know, he's also a lawyer, but he's a carpenter, just like the Lord Jesus Christ. So in honor of Easter, I said, Dad, while you're here, Ava's got a swing in the backyard, and one of the slats is broken. I don't want her to get splinters, and you would be the guy to get it right. You could go back there. You could replace that wood. You could paint it. You'd stain it so the little Ava can swing on her swing when the pool's open. That's all I ask of you, Dad. And you said, yeah, no problem. And now here you are showing your true feelings of resentment for being asked to do anything around the house.
It was wonderful.
Okay. Yeah.
I went out and I looked at it. It's a job that I could easily do.
Okay, good. Not oh, they're asking about your magnum opus poem. Will you recite it? He said, can't recite it. It's a book. Now, you want to tell people about the crossing and what's happening there?
Wow. You're giving me a chance to do that here?
Yeah, sure.
Finally, after all these years, this is a book that I wrote. It's just one long poem because I wanted to be like Homer. I wanted to be like Virgil. I wanted to be like Milton. I wanted to write an epic poem. So it's a book-length poem. It's called The Crossing, An Epic Testimony of Jesus Christ. And lo and behold, I finally got it into the hands of a publisher. I've been so busy, I haven't been able to spend any time on all of this. It's, you know, it's involved. You know from publishing a lot of stuff, it's more than just writing. You have to...
It's a lot of work. It is.
Yeah, all the marketing and promotion that has to be done is... It's crazy, and I'm finding out, and I don't know whether I can really stand up for it. But it's a book about the journey of a colony of people from the Tower of Babel all the way to a promised land led by the Lord. And it explains how every impediment in our life can be overcome through the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what it's about, son.
Well, it sounds good, Dad. And when you publish it, I'll put it out there so that people who want to purchase a copy are able to do that. They can support you by these guys. They're talking about, you know, wanting your book to succeed.
Really?
Yeah, of course. That's what we do here is we promote books and things like that. So why wouldn't I promote my father's book?
Comic books, though. This is just has, you know, there's no illustrations. It's just.
Yeah, I know, but it's still a book, and it's religious, and if anybody would like to support you, when you have it done, I will put the link out there, and people can purchase a copy.
May 15th is when it will be released.
Here we go, Monster Mania. Fightins need pitchers. What time are you picking me up for the game? Buy your dad a beer. Dude, I'd love to bring you. My dad does not drink.
No.
Does not drink at all, do you?
Never tasted it.
Never had any alcohol. What he does do. You want to tell them what you do or you have indulged in?
I don't know whether
some
that's
pharmaceuticals. You're not too no. Oh, I don't drink, son. I don't drink alcohol. I just take acid. Okay, Dad. Little hashish. Little smoking some doobies.
Well,
but no alcohol, so that's good, Dad. So you could feel like you're better than some people, the drunks.
I don't think I'm better than anybody. Everybody's struggling with something or other. You know,
yeah.
I'm not better than anybody.
No, I know that.
I'm just trying to get by. I'm old now, you know that. I'm old.
You're one of the best, Dads, really. I'm so happy. You know, look, there, we had some distance between us. And what happened was I started dating that woman upstairs.
Oh, she's wonderful.
And she insisted on getting us back together again and fixing our relationship.
Oh, gosh, bless her heart.
And she did that, didn't she?
She's an angel.
Yeah, she Andrea
did that.
Is like,
I didn't realize that, but if she did that, that's
she did. We were fighting, and Andrea said, "You two can't fight." No, we were not close. 2014, and she
never fight though.
No, I know you're passive aggressive, but we fixed it, and I gotta say I'm really glad because I think our relationship as father and son. Has been great the past 10 years. It's really been really good.
I'm going to cry.
Yeah, it's been nice. You're always welcome here. You want to stay here? You want to move in? When you become old and infirm, you want that bedroom
man.
Upstairs?
I am there. I am old and infirm. Social Security said I only have 11.41 years left. 11.41.
I could do that standing on my head. You want to you want to move in upstairs? No problem. You'd be always welcome.
Oh, that's very kind. Thank you. I know that.
And we'll go to Phillies games every season. That's 11 seasons of the Phillies.
11.41.
We'll catch most of the 4-1. 4 months. Hopefully that'll be the beginning of a season.
Okay.
You know, I'll bring you out there.
Well, sounds good.
All right, well, let's look at the Eric July thing here that we're looking at. Now, Eric July, he put out a book, Dad. I'll just show you the...
I've heard his name before.
Yeah, I know. You read Ice on and you said it stunk.
It does. I don't want to put anybody down. He's a child of God and all that.
Yeah. You said it stunk. My dad, I was being very kind to Eric July, and I was kind of saying, no, like, this is his first effort, you know, and... We got to be nice and say, no, this is great, and it'd be encouraging. You came on this live stream. You said, I read it. It's a piece of garbage. It stunk. And I said, Dad, what that? No, Dad. And you've been consistent about that, saying that Isom was a piece of garbage. And it's not like you care. Like, you're not, I really want a black man to succeed. There's none of that with you.
No.
You're just sitting there reading it and going, objectively.
I love everybody.
As a man who's been reading comic books since when was the first comic book that you got? Do you remember?
Man, it could have been, it was either Superman or Batman or Sergeant Rock or something like that. It was way back when.
What year? Do you want to?
Years.
In the 50s or the 60s?
Late 50s.
Late 50s.
Yeah. 58, 59. Probably a Superman. I think my favorite was Batman, but Superman was right there, neck and neck. But Superman, from another planet.
Yeah.
Batman was someone who was mortal. And I had an opportunity, perhaps, of becoming like Batman, you know? Chance. I mean, Anyway, that's the way I identified with it.
Yeah.
Super smart. Guy always came up with great ideas to fight crime. Slick.
And then you were reading all through the 1960s and then into the 70s when you started our family and you were reading Conan the Barbarian, Marvel Comics series. Your favorite artist was drawing that. You're still your favorite artist.
Jeez, I don't know. You're my favorite now.
Thanks, Dad. before I was a comic book artist, your favorite comic book artist was?
Barry Windsor Smith. This guy, it was like a revolution in comics.
Dad, do you want a chair? You want to grab? They're insisting that you sit. You want to grab one of those chairs over at the table and bring it over here?
Yeah.
They're light.
Although I do have a personal problem, you know, that maybe I should mention.
Whoa, what's that? If I have a shirt flung over one of them, just throw that off there.
This one over here?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. They have these, what do you call them? The life vests, you know, on the planes?
Yeah.
And you pull the red thing and they inflate.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Yeah.
But they're really good for old men who have certain problems.
Oh, yeah?
You probably noticed the way I've been kind of walking wide.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, when you get old, things happen. My dad had surgery for hemorrhoids.
Mm-hmm.
Piles.
Yeah.
Terrible thing.
Sheila Alien's already guessed.
I went to a doctor. Proctologist, I think they're called. Do you want to hear this? You're talking about isom. You don't want to talk about hemorrhoids.
No, I don't want to talk about that. I mean,
no, it's not a pleasant subject. Anyway, those inflatable vests, if you inflate them on the plane and sit on them, if you have this particular problem, works really well.
That's great, Dad. Thanks. Thanks for letting me know.
Well, it's more than that, though. You know what the proctologist said?
What?
I don't know if I should talk about it on air. Well, anyway, I'm in that position, you know. And he said, all I can hear were things like, oh, my God. You know, but I wouldn't say the God word, you know, but you should have heard him. What he was saying. And saying things like words that I wasn't familiar with. Homunculus? Have you ever heard of a homunculus?
Yeah, it's like a small person.
Or a teratoma? So evidently, my Siamese twin brother has emerged.
That's a lie. This is a lie, Dad.
Come on, look at me.
This is a lie.
Why
do you... You had me going for a minute, but this part is a lie.
Oh, how can you say that?
Dad, look at this. Instead of lying, instead of continuing the lie.
He's your uncle, okay?
Mm-hmm. This is the Isom official original concept art of Ripaverse Comics. Now, you read Isom number one, and you were fascinated by it in a lot of ways.
Spells Mosi backwards.
Mosi backwards, yeah. Is it a biblical name? Can you think of a reference of Isom from the Bible?
No.
No.
Not at all. You know, though, I was thinking about... don't want to hear about your uncle.
I don't want to hear about it. No, please.
I'm not going to tell you about your uncle.
Leon just says, isom or hemorrhoids? That's a tough choice. Yeah, like, which one would you prefer? Which one would you prefer to talk about or have?
I don't have hemorrhoids.
No.
I don't have that.
Okay. Let's go Phillies. That is all, says Tommy Reviews. Aerosworld said, will you publish your book and fulfill through Ripascend? Ripascend will publish and fulfill my dad's book. My wife did the same thing for me and my father, but she also called me yesterday a young Bon Jovi, so lol. I was wondering, Comic Skate King Marduk Knight? Death Network says...
People.
Oh, yeah, your boy sent me the wrong package. I've emailed more than once, an eBay message a few times, and nothing. Oh, yeah, that's right. They sent you Death Networks, I know you. They sent you another silver envelope of all of our books that are really expensive instead of sending you what you were supposed to get. I know. They'll take care of you. Trust me. Headrock says, Jesus Christ, give your dad a goddamn chair.
Oh.
Terrible language.
Oh, awful.
Just came over from West. Hi, Holiday. EVS, did I miss you talking about C2E2? Yeah, I talked about it like the first 30 minutes of the show. So if you want to get my take on that, you can go back and listen. Did your dad just mention Barry Windsor Smith? Says Lord Tapman's Comics. Yeah.
Yes.
He's a big fan.
Huge fan. I love those first 24 issues of Conan the Barbarian. I was back in the Army back then. I bought them at the PX, and couldn't wait for the month to come, you know, for that issue to come. Awesome art.
Yeah.
It was just so good. Detailed. I didn't like the way the colors bled, you know. Now you have more control over the colors, but still, the storylines were great. Yeah.
Who was writing back then? Who was the writer of Conan?
Well, they were based on Howard's books, right?
Yeah, but who wrote the comic book?
I don't remember. I don't recall. I'll have to grab one and find out.
Yeah, like you barely care about the writer. It's all about the art when you're with the Winsor Smith.
It's awesome.
Pilgrim Media says, talk about the golden tablets in before Salt Lake. Pramvakalati says, we are struggling with Eric July. Matt Grendel says, my dad had a huge, crazy belly button because of a fetal twin. It can happen.
See that? See? That's what I wanted to tell you about.
This is the cutest trash cast ever, says Dean Shock. Did you read Barry Windsor Smith's Machine Man, says Lord Tapman's Comics.
Did I? Machine Man. I don't recall.
You know who Machine Man is, a Jack Kirby character.
Mm.
And I think Barry Windsor Smith drew a four-issue miniseries in the 80s, which was really, it was beautiful work.
Really?
Yeah, Prambak Gulati says, I guess you didn't have ice on back in the day.
No.
Holiday, what is your favorite of your son Noah's comics, says Neon Knight Rider. You want to answer that question or you want to not answer it?
That's hard, but Blammo, I suppose.
Blammo?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's really hard. Because there's a lot of profanity, a lot of vulgarity in it. It's hard for me. But sometimes he does do art based on stories that I tell him that are funny. And he gives me copies of those, and I really enjoy those.
Yeah. Yeah. He's doing a new thing called Maple Terrace, where he's telling fictionalized stories this time. Stories that aren't true. About the family. And he has you in there saying, McFarlane comics aren't for real men. Barry Windsor Smith. Now, that is a lie. Like, you were a big Todd McFarlane fan.
Huge.
You collected all the, and treasured your McFarlane Spider-Man collection, which you paid more than cover price for. And you love Todd McFarlane. So he was wrong about that.
He lies a lot about me for some reason. He has a lot of latent hostility toward me. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, it is what
it is.
It's
a hard subject.
Yeah, it's uncomfortable. You don't have to worry about that, Dad. Let's make fun of Isom instead.
Mosey.
Isom. So this book here was the original official concept art of Ripaverse Comics, 8 pages long, and it cost $75.
Whoa!
It's $75. Now, here's what it is. You open it up, and it has this. This is the art.
Oh,
see
awful.
The... look at that!
Jeez!
Oh, my goodness. Look at her. She's working out, Dad.
Where's the...
She's working out with a 8-pound dumbbell,
well,
Dad.
These look like sketches for, you know, perhaps a work in the future, but there's no reality to it at all. You know, it's just...
Dad, this superheroine...
That's a superheroine?
Yeah, she can lift a 8-pound dumbbell. I want you to really examine, like, what her powers are. She can do push-ups.
Look at her arm. Look at that. That's not correct.
No.
None of this is correct.
No.
How many fingers does she have there? They're all pointed.
Yeah, she's got a lot of fingers. And then over here... oof, look at this hand. Over here, she's, like I said, curling that dumbbell.
Heck?
Yeah. Like, it'd be cool. Like, what you want to do is you want to, like, if she's strong, you want to have her holding, like a 800-pound dumbbell. Like,
yeah.
She's curling that, and you're like, wow, that is, she is strong.
But look at the fingers, how weird they are.
Yeah, these are bad drawings.
So what is this? Is this, like, a study for a future work or something? There's some possibilities.
Yeah, this is...
And her head's not right. It's not in proportion. Yeah. Look at that nose. What is that?
I don't know. Look at her weird, like, body. Like, it's a...
Yeah.
She looks trans. Would you say she looks trans?
I don't know.
Hmm.
I don't know.
Like a man, you know, dressed like a woman. That's what trans is.
Yeah.
Yeah. The intention of Isom number one, this is Eric's writing here, was not just to introduce Isom and his story, but to also serve as a launching pad for an entire universe. So we absolutely had to write a story that made sense so that we could bring in other characters that would play vital roles later. You understand, Dad? That's what this was for.
Okay.
You know, it's...
$75 for how many pages?
For 8.
Is it just a fundraiser or something for
no, it was already all
veterans or what the heck?
Can you imagine like being a comic book fan and then just ending up with this? I mean, it's brutal, absolutely brutal, Dad.
Yeah, but I don't want to put the guy down because, you know, I'll tell you the truth. He draws better than I can draw.
Yeah. This is not his drawings, though, Dad. But can he write better? He's the writer. He's not the artist.
Okay.
He
hired... Concentrate on the writing, huh?
Yeah, we're concentrating on the writing here.
Okay.
Yaira was one of the few characters that I created. What about Yaira? Is that a biblical word? Is it Hebrew?
No, I never heard of it before.
Yaira.
I was talking to people the other day about the meaning of their names.
Mm-hmm.
Like Michael. Your friend Michael. He wanted to know what his name meant.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, in Hebrew, it's pronounced Michael, who is like God. It's a question. Michael. Some people say it means one who is like God, but that's not correct. It's a question. Michael, and the inference is that no one is.
No one's like God.
He's too amazing, you know? Yeah. And you have the L on the end, you know, and that means that's God.
Right.
Right? L is God. And you see that in a lot of names, like Yoel and Ezekiel, and there are lots of them. I often tell people to go to L. Well, I give advice, yeah.
To God, yeah. You mean, but you mean God by that. You don't mean like, yeah, when you say, why don't you go to L?
Yeah, go to God.
You mean go to God.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep. But right. Jaira, no. Or Tyra, or whatever it is. No, I have never heard that name before. It's not Bible. Oh, yeah. Look at scripture.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Zachary, upstairs, Zachariah,
mm-hmm.
He asked me, what does my name mean? Well, Zachar is Hebrew for remember, and it's in the perfect tense, which means he remembered. Yah on the end means Jehovah, or Yah, or Yahweh, or the Lord. The Lord remembered. And I can imagine a mother originally, you know, praying for the birth of a son. She wanted a son so bad, and she prayed and prayed, and God remembered her prayer and gave her Zachariah, Zachar. He liked that. Your other friend up there, I had no idea.
Brighton
is not Hebrew.
It's not a real name. It's it's a fake name. But what about Yaira? What would that mean? Y-A-I-R-A.
I don't know. I don't know. What? You ask. I don't know. Yaira. Huh. Yeah. I don't know. It doesn't ring any bells.
Yeah.
I think somebody made it up.
Yeah. Goofball Boomer Uncle says, remember when Ethan prayed in church and ended with gay men? I do remember that.
No.
I said, in the name of Jesus Christ, gay men. And it killed everybody, dude. It killed. It did not kill you. You grabbed me by my ear and you took me outside. And you said, don't you ever do that in the house of the Lord again.
I don't remember. My memory is not what it used to be, man. It's all starting to slip away, you know. It really is.
Yeah, you're supposed to say amen. You're not supposed to say gay men. I think that's so ridiculous.
We had a problem like that going for a while.
All right, let me see here, Dad. So we got Yaira doesn't mean anything, apparently. Some people said it does, like it means it's some angelic reference. Anyway, this is due to the fact that I had great intentions for her, and she'll be a very prominent character of the Ripaverse. After documenting her backstory, I wrote the description of the character. It was almost as if I had to create two different looks for it, because I wanted there to be a visual... It was almost as if I had to create two different looks, because I wanted there to be visual changes to Yaira when she goes from her rest stage to her powers being activated. I want to bang my head against the wall
with
this.
That's a very complicated sentence there.
It sure is. let's go through it. It was almost as if. Okay, it wasn't almost. It was.
Yeah.
See, this is... Eric July likes to speak and write with all these extra clauses and sentences, like words that don't belong there. He just creates these thickets of commentary that you get entangled in, and you're just like... You sit there trying to... And you're trying to find the basic thought and extract it. Here's the thought. Here's what he's trying to say here. So we get rid of it was almost as if, because it was. I had to create two different looks.
There should be a comma after looks.
Comma. Because I wanted there to be a visual change in Yaira from when she uses her powers to when she is not using her powers. That's it. That's the entire thought that people that he's trying to say here, and it's all couched in like this.
So what is it about this that you need to do this?
It's for fun.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
The first thing we worked on regarding the concept art was how she looked at rest. I wanted her to have familiar features while also being abnormal, even when she's not using her powers. Therefore, she's very tall. Marco sketched the art of her working out based on based on my description. So I want you to draw her doing push-ups and lifting a tiny dumbbell. Can do. Of the book. At this time, we also created what she looked like when activating her powers in street clothes. I didn't want her to wear her suit in the main story, but I knew it was important to design. We handled her suit after we did the work for some of the other characters, and Marcos honestly led the charge on the design. I gave him some basic ideas, and he knocked it out of the park. There you go.
Okay.
I wish somebody would knock it out of the park today. That'd be nice to see.
We're gonna see that. There are going to be some home runs today on our side.
You think so?
Schwarber, yep. I think Harper, I think he heard it from the fans yesterday, that you're not watching the ball all the way back. You're taking your eyes off the ball. I went up there and I analyzed his swing. They played the game, replayed the game on TV, and I'm looking. And the guy, one thing about Pete Rose, he was a hit leader. He hit more balls than anybody, more singles, more doubles. He would watch that pitch come all the way into the catcher's glove. He never took his eyes off of it. Harper, nah, he wasn't doing that yesterday. So that's why we saw.
I can see them like looking defeated and bored and they don't want to be there. Like, I know when I see Alec Bohm go out there, I'm like, Alec Bohm is somebody who beats himself up. So he goes out there and he's just like, I'm going to do better this time. And he goes out there looking a wild animal ready to hit the ball. Determined.
He was great.
Stott is like, I'm a little guy here and I'm underrated and I'm going to show them this year. And he gets out there and he does great work too. And then everybody else is sitting around resting on their reputations. You know, it's like Schwarber hasn't hit a Schwar bomb in I don't know how long.
It's been a while.
And these guys, they're our leadoff batters are not doing anything. They all went 0 for 4 yesterday.
These guys are so good. I love their comments. I wish I could just get a copy of all their comments.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy them. I appreciate them very much. You have a great, great group of community, friends here. Yeah.
Well, they're not my friends. A lot of them are just here to make fun of me. But
Stott's going to have a great year, Richard.
Yeah, I agree.
I can feel it.
Living in the great big world.
Did pretty well yesterday.
With my head up in outer space. I know I'll go B-A-O.
Trey Turner, though, he let one get by. He should have caught. These guys, they just want to reach for him. They don't want to get in front of him because I think there's some kind of fear or something. You shouldn't be afraid of a fastball at this level, you know?
No.
Get in front of the ball.
Get it.
If you can't get it in your glove, at least it'll bounce off your chest and it'll be in front of you, you know? And you could maybe, I don't know, these guys.
What the F after all my pitiful support? No, I appreciate your pitiful support. It's been great.
These are great guys.
We're ready to go. I mean, we're ready to do it today. Now, Dad, we got somebody who, hold on a second.
$75 for that, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
$75.
Well, what is it? Is he running for office or something and he's getting contributions for his political campaign? Is that what this is about?
Well, that would make sense. I mean, you know, crowdfunding is like, we initially, when we started crowdfunding, we'd say like, look, the books are going to be a little bit more expensive than usual because we need more money to build up these businesses and to get things going. We're going to have smaller print runs of better quality books. So we're $25 for, you know, a Cyberfrog comic or for Jawbreakers.
I look like George Lucas, he says.
Yeah.
That's a compliment.
No, it isn't. Have you seen him lately? You know, $25 because you want to have like a beautifully printed book with a smaller print run. And so that's the whole thing. But that kind of led to this sort of entitlement where it's just like every single book is $25. Dad, like this. You know, $25 for manga. Man, this is a Japanese. You want to see this?
Myself. Jeez.
$25 for this quality quality comics.
Holy cow, man.
Yeah.
Well, look at that.
Mm-hmm. Is it good?
No. Oh, I'm sorry. You know, I don't want to put anybody down, but this... Well, it's not for my age group. You know, maybe kids.
Kids. Yeah, little kids.
Little kids.
Japanese yeah, kids.
But it's not. It's not good literature.
You know? Oh, I mean, hold on a second. Let's get your review of this.
Oh, wow. What is it?
That is Inglourious Rex number one.
Well, take it's a look step at that. Up from that.
That's for sure.
Hmm. Okay. Now we're talking.
$25.
That's fair. This is got a lot of pages here. Wow, this is good stuff. Whoever did this learned something from you. All right, we're talking costumes here.
Yeah. What do you think? See, those are like good sketches of character designs.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Do they know what I'm looking at?
Yeah, Inglourious Rex, Volume 1, by Davis and Lynn.
Hmm. And it's what, $25?
Yeah.
That's fair. This represents a lot of work and a lot of skill.
What if I told you that the person who drew that hates my guts and wants me dead?
Oh, it's terrible work.
No. Because it doesn't matter. It's so... You're supposed to say, be honest.
How could anybody hate you,
man? I don't know.
Mr. Sunshine.
It's true. No, that's my friend Shane Davis, one of my dearest friends who produced that book. Wow. So, I mean, this is your objective opinion about it.
Yeah.
You didn't know that, so.
No, this is good stuff. This is what we're talking about. This is what we want.
And he didn't know, like, Isom, he didn't know that was, you know, that guy was my friend or anything like that. He looks at the books and he just says what
there
he thinks.
It is. I always. Yeah,
to be honest.
I'll tell you my honest opinion about that. I'm from Jersey, and we always speak from the heart.
Of course. Yeah.
You know, so.
Look how good that is.
Well, it's pretty darn good. I mean, I like the way, you know, the variety and the layout. The way.
The colors look good.
Yeah. It's all good. I love detail, too, man. I could stare at some of this stuff for a while. This is good. Look at the emotion in this guy's face. I mean, that's real.
Yeah, it looks like a real character, right? It looks like a real person.
Yeah. No, I'm impressed. You tell this guy, Shane Davis. Is he listening?
No. He's traveling right now.
He does good work.
Yeah, he sure does.
Wow. Penciled by Shane Davis, inked by Yanzi Lin. Is he a friend?
Yanzi is his wife. Oh. Yeah. Yanzi Lin.
Man. I'm impressed.
There you go.
Good stuff.
Yeah. I mean, this is Inglourious Rex. It gets a good review from my father, who doesn't just give out good reviews.
I guess I have to buy it now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Buy Inglourious Rex, too. Mm. All right. So we got a lunatic here who thinks that Comicsgate is a cult. And this guy's very strange. His name is Sturgis.
Oh.
So we're going to take a look at a Sturgis video, a little bit of it. We're going to leave pretty soon. I don't want to...
Is he from South Dakota?
I don't know where he's from. Why would you think he's from South Dakota?
There's a big biker gathering every year in Sturgis, South Dakota.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah. No. I don't know where he's from, but he's a very strange guy. Let's see. He's very angry, and he loves Eric July. He loves Ripa Burst, and he hates us.
So this guy...
Right
here. Has made $1.3 million on this?
On the new book, Yaira. Yeah. The one that we looked at, well, he's selling books for like $75
a
piece.
Oh, my gosh.
And that's just one of the extra books. Why aren't we doing that, Dad? How come we're not, like, bilking the fans?
I don't want to bilk anybody. I want to give them fair value, like the book by Shane. That's fair value.
Fair value. This is garbage.
Yeah. Why would anybody do that unless they were part of a...
A cult.
a cult, you know, some kind of a secret combination. I mean, I don't know why.
So you're saying that Sturgis here is probably projecting, because he would be somebody who believes in paying an inordinately huge amount of money for trash. That, you know, this guy, he talks about picking up. You don't have to pick up these comics from this campaign. Eventually, a guy like this is going to end up picking them up off the ground with a pointed stick and an orange jumpsuit.
Right, right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's no reason to pay for this. They're going to be littered on the ground eventually. It is going to happen. All right, let's watch Sturgis.
Hello, everyone. I'm Renown Zero, and all hail Ripperverse, because apparently liking something and being a fan of something is being in a cult. Oh, okay. No.
Can you hear him at all?
No, I'm watching him talk, but I can't hear
him. You can't hear him? All right, hold on a second. Let's get the audio going here so you can actually participate.
Is that the artist?
No, he's a cult member, somebody who supports. He's like a big fan. A big, big fan.
Okay. He must be on the payroll?
No, he's too stupid for that. Like, I shouldn't say anything mean. That's not nice.
I don't want to say it either. I really don't want to criticize anybody in this world. I hear you. I have enough problems myself.
You have enough problems yourself?
Yeah, I got enough problems. You know, I don't want to judge. Judge not that you be not judged, you know.
Mm-hmm. People are impressed that Ethan has ears. That's right. I looked at myself and I said, boy, I look different. And I said, oh, it's because my ears are out. You can see what my head looks like. Mostly these people just see me with headphones on all the time.
Oh.
So I look really different right now. All right, let's take a look at Sturgis.
No, because when you call out the nonsense, they like to act as if you're the cult and you're the clown and you're the this and you're the that, but when you apply the same logic to them, it's okay. No. It's fine when they're doing stuff. It's fine when they're doing the things that we accuse you of. We're going to accuse you of things and say that I don't have any real proof, but I'm just going to say you're a bad thing and you're a liar, even though you're not going to show any proof because you're a huge bitch. Well, let's get into this right here. $1.304 million.
Did you see that? He said that we were huge B-words.
Mm.
He already seems angry to me.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's so mad. Like, what is Sturgis mad about?
He might have Tourette's syndrome.
Oh.
That's what it is. You gotta have mercy on guys like this.
I do, Dad. I have mercy on him. I just watch him and see what he's saying.
$1 for Yaira, 9,490 total purchases, over 16,000 books sold. Completely blowing out AlphaCore, because the people that showed up for AlphaCore are going to be, no one's going to show up for Yaira. Who's going to show up for Yaira that didn't show up for AlphaCore? Literally different people, because different people show up for Batman and different people show up for Superman and different people show up for Wonder Woman and different people show up for Spider-Man. It's always been like that.
Dad, the whole thing about this is, like, I think that he's got an argument here, and he's saying that, like, different people are going to buy different comic books that Eric July puts out. And I don't think he's correct about that. I think that it's an interesting study, like, what's going on here. I think Eric July puts out a book and then Sturgis buys them no matter what. But there are fewer and fewer Sturgises that show up. The idea that they have is that it's like Marvel Comics. You might buy Conan, but you might not buy Ghost Rider. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it isn't like that. It's just one guy and his fans that are buying everything that he puts out, or fewer and fewer of them. It's not like people are going, hey, Yaira isn't for me. I'm more of an Ice Home guy. That's what I think is going on. I don't know.
I don't understand. I don't understand how you can make that kind of money on that book. I don't understand the mentality of these people.
You're seeing it. You're seeing the mentality.
It's not a new concept. Just like different people show up for things like Blade Devil 2, Chains of Blood, like myself, who got every single cover because it looks awesome. Loved Blade Devil 1. If you want to get in on it, right here, Blade Devil 1 at Sick Fox Studios Unlimited on Indiegogo for just $10. You can get yourself a foil cover just like I did. Also, if you are on Twitter, the campaign for Death, Death, Death has been taken down. But if you do DM Joe Ball over on Twitter, you can still get an order
this
in
is good what
to
he's
get
doing
his
here.
300-page book for
$30.
Comments. Let's check out
which
some
I
of the line artwork
I like
that he did,
that.
Which I say is 1,000 times better.
I mean, the
than
problem is it's
EGS
coming from him. I
out.
Wouldn't want to buy
so we're going to start here
with
this
so
weirdo The Cult of Good Comics. I said, you misspelled Late Comics. And I also said, how do you have good comics when you don't have any to read? Is how can you say you have good comics when you're not getting any? Because EVS is not sending them out.
I mean, mostly their talking points. When people are saying that Ripaverse is bad, people respond, like people like this respond by saying, yeah, but, you know, Comicsgate is late. Ethan Van Sciver is late. That is the defense. To which it's a good defense. I mean, I just kind of say, yeah, my books are late. You know, the stuff that I do takes longer to put out than I initially estimate. But my stuff's good.
It's the best. It's the apex.
And when look at the stuff that we do here, I mean, I don't think there's any comparison between.
I was watching a draw the other day. Yesterday was it? And oh my gosh! I'm like, totally. It's mm-hmm. profound what you do, son. Unbelievable. I don't know how you do it. I really don't. Yeah. It's so different from everything you see out nowadays. It's just so good.
Well, thanks, Don. I'm trying my best.
It's the height. It's the evolution of art in comics.
So this is the question. I mean, this is the it's the quantity versus quality argument here that's being had. Ripaverse versus Comicsgate. Like, what's more important to you?
Is quality.
Most people would say, but I mean, it's like I'd rather have the book on time than wait for it. You know what I mean? Even though it's not going to be very good, at least it's on time, and this guy can do a book that's on time. On the other hand,
it's 8 pages, and you got to pay $75 for it.
There's that argument. You're paying too much for a book that's on time and isn't very good.
Yeah, I'd rather you take your time. You have to understand the artist. You know, what you do requires a lot of care. A lot of just, I don't know how you do it. I'm baffled, you know, always when I look at you and you scribble those blue lines all over the page and you somehow you make art out of that, you know, that looks like Rembrandt. I don't understand it at all. I'm still profoundly.
They're making fun of you. Trevor Wright goes, 4 years is a lot of time. A lot of time. Well.
Oh, well.
You can do a comic in 30 minutes or it's free, so Scientific Lens.
I used to do those caricature sketches, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And pretty fast. I mean, it was amazing how quickly you could make something really, really beautiful. A person just sitting there in the mall, you know. Yeah,
that was fun. Well, I mean, there's a bunch of different ways that you could do this. I don't, you know, you could go fast. I could do caricatures, you know, and stuff like that. It's all good. But making comics is a little bit different, especially when you're trying to tell a good story.
Yeah, in the best way.
Yeah. See more of this guy.
Someone needs to pick up their cult member and bring him to a mental hospital and help him with that Eric derangement syndrome he caught from EVS. You have man boobs. I reported you to FBI because you look like an okay dude. You're short. Yeah. Shut up.
Oh,
F Eric July. He's a loser.
For entertainment. I mean, you know, why would I do this? Ordinarily, I wouldn't. But this is a show, and it's a show of entertainment. So we've got two sides that are currently fighting. And what would we do? Well, we want to kind of examine what their points are and then laugh at them or rebut them in some way. Here's somebody, Big Robot News Today says, Ethan says you're disturbing. I find him disturbing. I do. I have to admit. I find him to be a disturbing individual. Katie Did's channel says, show your dad the Cyberfrog animation. Oh, yeah. you might want to see this, Dad.
Who did it for you?
Well, an individual named Wundun. And did it for.
Wundun?
Yeah, like WND. WUNDUN.
Huh.
Ready?
I took a couple of Chinese Watch. Friends to the shooting range. Wow. Look at this. One and done, huh?
What do you think of that?
Reminds me of the guys I took to the shooting range.
Mm-hmm.
Way too high and shoot too low.
What do you think of this, Dad? Got another backer on that? Here he is again. All right, hold on. Hey, Donnie Cates.
Ethan, how you doing, pal?
Good, I'm live right now. Like, people can hear you, so I'm warning you of that right now. Like, I'm actually doing a live stream right now. You want to say hi to Comicsgate?
Every time I look at you, I don't understand why you let the things you did get so out of hand. You'd have managed better if you'd had it planned. Now why'd you choose such a backward time in such a strange land? If you'd come today, you could have reached the whole nation. Israel in 4BC had no mass communication.
Don't you get me wrong.
Don't you get me wrong.
Don't you get me wrong. No, no.
Don't you get me wrong.
Don't you get me wrong.
Only wanna know. Only wanna know. Only wanna know.
I want you to imagine that the industry that you gave 25 years of your life to simultaneously worked together to convince the general public that you were a Nazi. And I want you to wonder to yourself if you would ever forget that or ever forgive that. Would you do that?
It is blasphemy.
I want you to think about what it would be like if leftist media publications on the internet all converged with the help and support of people who you consider to be your peers to convince the general public that you were a bigot, a homophobe, a racist, and a Nazi. Is there any way that you would ever forgive those circumstances?
What you think about your friends at the top?
Look at this.
Now who'd you think besides yourself was a pick of a crop? Buddha, was he where it's at? Is he where you are? Could Mohammed move a mountain, or was that just PR?
Don't make peace with me. Make peace with them, Donnie, because I'm not going to betray my fans by publicly endorsing your behavior. All of this positivity shit is bullshit. Apologize to the fans who supported you, and you demonize them all when you demonize Comicsgate.
So there it is. That's the, you know, a meme somebody made about, me being crucified.
Holy crumb.
In the media, you know, not in real life, you know. Is that blasphemous? Yes?
You're asking me?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. I don't think so. Maybe.
All right, let me look at some super chats here and see what people are saying. Let me see. Hey, Dad, check out Barry Windsor Smith's new book called Monster. Lord Tatman's Comics.
I will.
Ten Letters says, but a hemorrhoid that gains sentience is a good story idea. It isn't a good story idea. It's terrible. Elvis's birthplace, less than 1 mile from Convention Center and Hotel in Tupelo, Mississippi, says David O'Bertram.
He understands. I wasn't given an opportunity to tell the whole story, but someday I will.
Thane Caudor says, show him the trailer. I'll show my dad the trailer. I don't know if I'm going to show it to him now because...
fixed his swing yet.
Has your dad fixed Ava's swing yet, says G-Dash. He's going to do it on Monday. I said Monday, after the holiday, you know.
Yeah.
Please, can I get a Fearsome Backers 785 update E, says Eldridge, CNTEDC. Fearsome update. We are, the artwork is finished. The scripting is not done yet. The lettering is not done. But we will be going to print very soon on the Fearsome preview book. That's your update for now. Right now we are, going to print with Snowman. We got Snowman coming out. We have, 1998, The Diary of Heather Swain, the large size going to print. Fearsome is next, and we've got the, race cars as well. Chad T.I., new member. Thank you for joining the channel. Dennis Rodriguez. Well, hello there. Ethan, your Ides of March Salamandroid deal arrived. Thank you. Hope to grab CyberFrog Spring Package 2 next week. Greetings from Germany.
Germany. Wow.
Yeah.
Look at that. I was there, Denise.
Das macht Spaß.
Mm-hmm.
Masked Ramen says, great guest. Hands down, my favorite episode. That's you. Yeah. Yaira, a girl's name from Hebrew. It means to illuminate, to enlighten, says Sean Connery versus Applesauce.
Not with the, it, you know, it's the why in front of it that bothers me. I understand what you're saying.
Val Schnitzel says holiday, and then he gives you this. What is he saying here?
Mirishon or, from the language of light. Okay, I can see that.
Oh, what is Val Schnitzel? You see what he's saying to you? Holiday. And he wrote, can you read this?
Yeah. He will enlighten, or she will enlighten, make light. Ya'ir Belashon, in the language or the tongue, Necheva means pleasant tongue. Melishon, or from the language of light, holiday.
Oh, so he's accentuating what Sean Connery said up here.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Yaira.
Hmm. Okay.
Well, that's not.
You don't think so?
Well, that's Ira. It's just Yira.
Mm-hmm.
Yira. I don't know.
No, I don't know either. I'd listen to you.
But I understand. Val, yeah. I can see it related.
Darmex says, if Ethan is an expert comic artist, then Dad must be superior. My dad taught me everything I know about comic books. Yeah, you should take me to the comic shop.
Yeah, but how can I teach you? It's like I just put you on the scent of it, and you just took off like a rocket. It's like my wife. I taught her genealogical standards, and she's like an amazing genealogist now, but it's not. What did I do? I just introduced her to it.
Headrock says, does Holiday have email? I can send a transcript. Why can't I get this to come up? I'm sorry about this, Headrock. I can send a transcript. Yeah, he does, but you know what? We're not going to reveal his email here. Okay, I don't think it's safe to do that. So we're not going to do that.
What's a transcript of what?
I don't know. Pilgrim Media says, EVS, how angry was Shane after that show? Very angry. He was unhappy about that whole thing, but he was also tired from being on the road. So I'm sure Shane will probably, when he comes back, he'll go live. You can talk to him and ask him about this whole thing. Shane has the letter that's coming from C2E2, and he's asking if he should put it up. I said I'm not sure yet, so I wouldn't do it right now. But I might be wrong about that. My instincts, when it comes to SJWs canceling us, my instincts are to not advertise that fact, because it just gives them more encouragement. They like it. They promote it. They laugh about it. It doesn't. You would think it would make people angry and everything. It doesn't. It's the opposite. It gives them something to celebrate and a scalp to hold up. And I don't like to give that stuff to them.
It's a relief, actually. And I'm pleased. For you. That you don't have to go into Chicago among that group of people. It's a dangerous place. You're vulnerable there. We're all vulnerable there. It's an awful, violent, nasty, degenerate place. And I'm just really pleased that you don't have to go there this year. They did you a favor. This is a great blessing.
Yeah, I know. I can see that. I agree with you. Captain Chokot says, happy Easter holiday, sir.
Thank you, Captain. Thank you. Same to you.
Here's Captain Chokeout. His beard looks like it's made of pubes. Yeah. Not you, Dad. They're not talking about you. They're talking about this guy up here that we were just looking at.
Oh.
Remember the... your beard looks elegant. So does mine, But that guy had like a...
Well, I'm a senior literary figure now that I'm publishing a book,
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I got to look the part.
Mr. V says, fun fact, Sturgis the homunculus also grew on someone's hemorrhoids. Life is a miracle. Show your dad the Cyberfrog Animations, Katie Did's channel. Thank you. EVS eats unbelievably. I don't know how he does it, says 200 Watts Studios.
He believes while he's eating.
You better believe it. Matt Grendel says, caricatures of Sturgis, Rippet, etc. Draw stream auction. 200 Watts Studios says, USD. Crazy Cat says, do you think Guardian Angel was looking over your little brother Noah when Ed Piskor said he didn't want to be photographed with a Van Sciver? See, I mean, yes. That was a really strange moment. Like, that made me not like Ed Piskor, and I don't care. Noah isn't out there being politically active at all.
Not at all.
And he should not have to pay the price for me and what I'm, my things that I'm saying and doing. And the idea that somebody would do that just means these people have no standards. I like the idea, whenever I see one of these disgusting SJW perverts saying that Noah is the good Van Sciver brother, it makes me happy. Because that's fine. If he gets treated better as a way of treating me worse, I think that's a fair exchange.
That's great.
When you punish him for, for being my brother, I think these people are scum. I mean, that's just inexcusable. Dark Low Comics, join the channel. Thank you very much.
Brian Cox.
Your dad looks like the actor Brian Cox, says. No, he doesn't. No, Marky did not. No.
I don't even know who to... thank you. If that meant as a compliment, I appreciate it.
Eric O'Sullivan says, hey, I caught up with C2E2. It's ironic you'd make Chicago an unsafe space, huh? Typical progressive tactics. Come to Boston Wicked in August. Boston's just as bad.
Yeah, it's getting there, isn't it?
I mean, can we have some conventions in conservative areas? That would be really, really nice. Carbon dioxide. I like Boston, too. I really like visiting there. A nice college town. I got to see Obama there.
It's a cradle of liberty there, too.
Yeah. Yeah. I like the people. I like Boston. But, yeah, the politics are terrible. I really don't think that, we'd be any safer or... when I say safe, I don't even want to say safe. I just... I don't think we'd get treated any more fairly there than we were in Chicago. Let's just put it that way. Indiana Jeremy, Father and Son Trashcast needs to become a new show. Daniel the Lamanite says, happy Easter, Van Sciver. He's LDS, Daniel the Lamanite.
Wonderful.
But he's a Lamanite, though.
Is
you
he
know
really?
What? Yeah.
Is he really?
Yes.
What tribe?
No, I'm not saying he's actually literally a Lamanite. I'm saying he's really LDS. I don't know, why he would want to associate himself with the Lamanites. Those aren't good people.
Why not? Lamanites? Yeah. In the Book of Mormon, they became, the whole characters of the people changed. They were converted, and they were more righteous than the Nephites.
Nate313 says, can't refund C2E2 tickets. It's lousy. Lousy of them.
Really?
I think you should push on that and demand refunds. I mean, I really think you should demand. If you want to get a refund... You should demand, because on their website, we were there, and they canceled us, and they must refund.
Yeah.
We didn't cancel. They canceled us, and you purchased in order to meet us, and if we're not there, then you refund, and they need to refund your money. And if they don't, there needs to be a problem made about that. That's a whole thing. You can say, their attitude about disinviting us is fair. It's their convention. I mean, they can do that if they want to do that. But you see, we were on that website. They'd approved us. They'd sold us the table. And people bought tickets because of that representation. And removing us, they need to refund people who purchased just to meet us.
I wouldn't go anyway. I'd just take the loss. I mean, if they won't refund, just take the loss. Mark it up to experience.
Well, I'm talking about the fans here. The fans need the refund.
I'm responding to that also.
Chargeback, cost the money, says Normie Nerd. There you go. I would do what you have to do, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not fair. It really isn't fair. And they should not get to keep your money.
No.
Over this.
Yeah. Fraud report. Stupid. I like that. Good.
Yeah.
Can I cancel for a ticket? You can try.
Yeah.
No, we're honest here.
Yeah.
We are honest.
All right, we're going to go. I think we're going to wrap this up because we got to get ready to go. In 28 minutes, we're heading over to the ballpark to go see the Phillies again, and hopefully they'll do better this time.
They got
to
do better. The relief pitching has got to show up, and we need some offense from the top four batters.
Yeah,
I mean, they got to hit something. Jeez, or walk or something. Get on base.
These guys think I have fake teeth. They go, they think I have dentures.
Huh, really?
Yeah.
No, you're one of the fortunate ones.
They're always saying stuff like this to me. I do have some...
They really look you over, don't they?
Yeah, all they do is look at my face. What? You know? Silliness.
They're wonderful people, though. I really enjoy looking at this thing over here on the side with their comments. They're just wonderful people. Great minds.
Alan Sparks, a member for 35 months, says, I finally got time to read Wrecked Planet and Salamandroid and Heartsick Horror. You, sir, stepped up hard from Blood Honey. Be proud. Looking forward to Rainbow and Fearsome and Frog. Frog 3.
Man.
No, they're not veneers at all. I got my teeth whitened. I had a whitening process, which was expensive and painful. But I really liked the results.
I should do that.
Yeah, it was really good.
I told Andrea last night, I'm a lot like George Washington, dentally.
I had a chip right here in the front of my tooth. This chip, like real big. It was so embarrassing. Luckily I got to the dentist the next day and they fixed it. But you can still, I don't want to get real close. But anyway.
Utah Comic Con, yeah.
Utah and Utah? Boxing historian 206 says Mariners are better than the Phillies. Are they?
They might be today. I don't know.
Oh, guys.
Look at all this. Big love for Holiday. Thank you. Oh, bless you.
ASC Presents says, have a fun day, Frog Family, from Clippa. Thank you for $5. We are going to have a fun day. I'm going to be drinking a couple of beers. Dad likes the pretzels. They have these great... Are you going to get another pretzel today?
Not today. I did too much salt. We did a bag of popcorn. We did the pretzel. We did a bunch of other salty stuff, and I'm going to hold back on the salt a little bit, and I'm just going to drink some water.
Holiday pay. Good to see you, says Eric Wimberg. Thanks for $10. I appreciate that.
Wow.
Yeah, if Hunter comes, I'll probably get a couple of beers. I was feeling good yesterday. I was really enjoying myself. But for some reason, I didn't feel like jumping up and down and yelling and screaming. Maybe it's because the team sucked. I really like to have a few beers and go, whoa! Like, you know, I could not do that yesterday. It was a humbling experience. It was morbid, almost, I would say. So I'm hoping we do better. It's fun to see them win. When we see a game where they win, we drive home and we're feeling good. We're listening to talk radio, like the sports. It's a great, great time when they win.
I have a soda maybe once a month at the most. I like fruit juices. I like water. Mm-hmm. I'm a very plain person.
Yakusei. Hey, Ethan. Hey, Holiday. Hey, chat. If there's no show tomorrow, have a happy Easter. There will be a show tomorrow. We're going to do an Easter trash cast tomorrow night with Cyberfrog special. There will be a complete story special package for Easter with like a special edition of Blood Honey, 1998 The Diary of Heather Swain, Wreck Planet, Salamandroid, Death Sting, and Heartsick Horror all together in a folder. We'll have that for you tomorrow. Limited numbers, maybe 100 of those. Maybe less than that. Maybe like 80 of those.
Look at all these people making comment, man.
Yeah, no, everybody's great.
Great people.
Yeah, really, really good. Okay, guys, thanks very much. We will see you. We'll see you tomorrow. I don't know. No, I'll be here tonight. I'll go live tonight. Thanks, guys. Have a great afternoon, and take good care of each other.
Happy Christmas. No, not Christmas. It's Easter.
Isn't Easter.
It?
Yeah.
Power of nature can bring you to the end of your life. And you should know by my smile and the look in my eyes that you're about to be massively forced to give up. Chicken attack, chicken attack. But you are back before it fades to black. Say my love, calm, bless, but then you can all chicken ass. So chicken go, oh, oh, oh. So chicken go, oh, oh, oh. Now gonna fly. With the power of nature, you're never alone, and you can't let it belong on the back. Every beast, every tree follows me to the end, and you're about to be massively chicken attack. Chicken attack. Watch your back before it fades to black. Say my love, come, let's pass them. Come on, chicken ass. Go, chicken, go. Go, chicken, go. Now gonna fly. You understand? You're younger. and you are hungry, perhaps your own money, I give to this chicken today. It's eggs for your dinner, it's legs for next winter, you won't have to steal a bee. Go chicken, go! Go chicken, go! Go chicken, go!